for that. We'll get that webcam going there. Anyway, you can see our cam over at cam.freetalklive.com whenever I actually get it on the line, which I have done. So back to the story here from Ethan Glover. He has pointed out that I've made some statement. He claims that if 1,000 people hate what we're doing, but if just one person researches what we present, the job is well done. I don't think I've ever actually said that, but what I have said is that I'm not really concerned with the percentages. It doesn't really matter to me whether 51% or 71% or whatever doesn't like whatever it is that we've done. I'm doing what I do to reach the people who do appreciate it. And I know those people are out there because they tell me so. I don't know if you've gotten any of this, Rich, over the last week or so, but I've had locals approach me and say thank you for what you did with Maggie Hassan.
Yeah, I've had that happen as well.
Right. So, you know, and if people were always giving negative feedback, if whatever we heard about what we did was negative, we did this thing where we cornered this lady and, you know, hit her with a bunch of questions on video, and 100% of the feedback or 99% of the feedback was negative, it would be really tough to keep going out and doing stuff like that. But it's not even close to, you know, 99%. I don't know what the percentage is, and as I said, I don't care. It's enough. I get enough positive feedback to where I feel like this is the right thing to do.
I mean, my specific goal, I guess, is to, on one hand, be outrageous enough to actually be watchable, because, you know, some of my message is going to Maggie Hassan, but most of my message is going to the rest of the world.
Right, the people who are watching the video.
Exactly. And, you know, as I recall, last time I looked, which was a while ago, it was something like 20 to 1 on thumbs up. And that's not always the case. I mean, you might think, well, this is your audience, so they're always going to like it.
That
but other people get
case.
Driven to that video.
That's true,
and they do somewhat answer.
But initially, you don't want to use YouTube views as an indicator of what people think, right? Because initially, the YouTube videos that we put out are going to go around the Liberty circles first. They're more likely to go to the Liberty people first. So they're more likely to be positively received up front. But I've seen over time those YouTube thumbs up, thumbs down shift because, like, for instance, there was a time when a video of Derek J. We're in Derek J's car in Manchester, and a cop pops his door open. That's a video that went viral, actually, later on. So it had been out there for a while, and then finally somebody posted it to a Reddit forum, and not everybody on Reddit's a libertarian. In fact, most of them are not. So people saw that video, and they were pissed about what we, you know, how we handled that encounter with the cop, which was, you know, we were outraged that this cop opened up this door. Like, he just pops a door open like he owns this car. And so, you know, we went back and forth with this cop in the video, but the people on Reddit hated this thing, but it went viral. The video got over 100,000 views. I think it might be up to like 600,000 or something ridiculous like that. But it shot up in view count, and it also shot up in dislikes. There were a bunch more dislikes placed on that video because it got outside of the Liberty circles. So you don't ever want to use to me at least, you don't ever want to use those thumbs up, thumbs down as any kind of indicator of whether it was effective activism or whether it reached the right group of people or at all.
Well, what sort of metrics do you use? Because that's something that I've been grasping for. And of course, you and I have talked about actually engaging a polling firm to do scientific polling. I would probably do it in the county and in the state. And that, of course, would be the holy grail, but that costs money that we don't have.
Yeah.
Not exactly holy grail, because if you do polling, phone polling, you're going to be doing polling of older people, generally.
Don't they have ways to call cell phones nowadays, or no?
Only if they opt into a list.
Yeah.
See, if we did it statewide, I've given this some thought, and as a computer programmer, if we did it statewide, then all we would have to do is generate random phone numbers in the 603 area code.
That's true.
Because that
don't start
happens
with one.
To...
No, there's no prefix that starts with one.
Okay. Right. Oh, yeah. There's a whole bunch of rules for prefixes, but these days, generally, you just would hit a list for the 603 area code on the web and parse out the list of exchanges and do that, because that's all on the web.
I think I don't oppose that idea, but as you said, it's going to take time. It's going to take money, and you know, we've all got a bunch of projects on our hands that we would prefer to spend our time and money on.
True. And we kind of, in the polling, we kind of lost the original question that I was asking in the context of the polling, which is what kind of metrics do you use to say this is doing more harm than good versus this is doing more good harm?
And maybe we'll find out what Ethan's metrics are here in a moment, what he considers to be important, because I think the answer is it depends on your perspective. If your perspective is that of the state, that you support the idea of the state, the structure of the state, the enforcement of the state, then to you, this kind of activism is doing damage. You know, it's hurting your state's legitimacy by having people not bow on, you know, bended knee in front of the governor and kiss her ring and things like that. From the perspective of somebody who wants to suck up to the state in an attempt to change it, they feel like it's hurting them. You know, we've had a lot of blame for the 420 celebrations here as we're the ones, because we've smoked pot publicly, we're the reason why marijuana decriminalization and legalization hasn't gone forward. So, I mean, there's all kinds of people out there with different goals and priorities and different opinions about whether or not this is or is not effective activism. To me, whether it's effective or not is indicated by the response I get from people. So if I'm out, you know, like I said, I got locals telling me thank you for doing this Maggie Hassan thing. So as far as I'm concerned, that was the right thing to do. And then also I've done things like don't take a plea deal outreach, jury rights outreach, things like that. And every now and then I'll get a compliment from somebody saying, hey, I really appreciated that information and thank you for sharing that with me. So I feel like I'm making a difference.
I was very pleased we got that thank you from the Keen Cannabis Coalition.
We'll come back with more on this here in moments. Tactics, it's Free Talk Live.
Warning. If you've recently declared bankruptcy, you're going to want to change the station. Because there's an alternative to bankruptcy, and it's faster than you'd ever think possible. But if you've already declared bankruptcy and have missed this opportunity, you'll want to change the station now. Here it is. Right now, the company that has resolved more credit card debt than anyone in the U.S. is available to settle your debt, too. You may reduce your debt with one low monthly program payment. If you call right now, Freedom Debt Relief will show you how low your monthly program payment could be for free. Call now. 1-800-399-1993. That's 1-800-399-1993. If you're struggling with debt, this could be your answer. And the bigger your debt, the more money you could save. To find out for free how much of your hard-earned money Freedom Debt Relief could help you save, call now. 1-800-399-1993. 1-800-399-1993. 1-800-399-1993.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938, 877-357-9938.
Farmers keep livestock lean and healthy with a mineral-rich diet. Then, before market, they cut off minerals, leaving them to crave high-calorie grains. If weight control is this easy, why prescribe surgery for humans? Introducing Youngevity. You could avoid 900 diseases by getting 90 essential nutrients from Youngevity. Check out 90 for Life at tobeyoungagain.com or call 855-79-YOUNG. That's 855-79-YOUNG or tobeyoungagain.com. Youngevity. It's all about saving money, getting healthy, and creating wealth.
If you're looking for work, or even if you're not, here's an innocent mistake you really want to avoid. Never return calls before listening to your voicemail. Your wireless phone sends calls you didn't answer into voicemail, and it shows you phone numbers for calls you missed. Important, don't call back callers you missed until you have first listened to your messages. Otherwise, you frustrate people who bothered to leave messages by asking them to repeat a message they just left, as your voicemail greeting instructed them to. If you're a job applicant, this alone could be a deal killer. And even if you're not, there are few things you can convey to someone that are as fundamentally maddening as, "I didn't hear you." With money and attention so scarce now, effective communication skills have never been more important. For more tips for job seekers and everyone else, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
If there was a place that liberty-minded people had been elected to political positions and were rolling back government, would you move there? If freedom lovers had secured a 20% voting block and can veto most bad bills, would you move? Well, the time has come to sign the pledge at freestateproject.org. These things have happened in New Hampshire, and you can join us and help. freestateproject.org. Sign up now at freestateproject.org.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can join us here on the radio waves at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733, and you can join us online at freetalklive.com. We've got Skype as well, by the way. Our Skype username here is lrn.fm. And if you are online, then you need to know about ProXPN. Somebody sent us a message on Facebook today asking, what is the discount code for ProXPN? It's FTL50. And that gets you 50% off the price of their annual account, which brings the price down to around $5 a month. But what do they do for you? They encrypt your internet connection. So your internet service provider, be it your cell phone company or cable modem or whatever, they don't know what you're doing anymore online once you start using ProXPN. They can't log the websites you visit, the search terms you enter. Many of them are doing that right now and keeping those logs for years. So you can stop that from happening by using ProXPN. Just go to proxpn.com/FTL. You can get started there. Download their free software for Windows, Mac, iOS devices, as well as Android and Linux. Go to proxpn.com/FTL. And then when you're ready to upgrade to their premium account, for unlimited bandwidth, servers around the world that you can access, you can privately torrent and get past regionally blocked websites, you can use that code FTL50, and you'll get that 50% off for the lifetime of your account.
We actually, what we do on the website is generally we have links, banner links for our advertisers. If I can get a banner out of the advertiser, we've got a link on the side of the freetalklive.com, and the ProXPN banner has FTL50 right there. So if for whatever reason you forget, you're wishing to know about an advertiser, try going to freetalklive.com and looking along the right-hand side. You're going to have to turn off ad block.
You get a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee with ProXPN, so you have nothing to lose except your privacy. So why wait? Go and get started for free right now at proxpn.com/FTL. And don't forget promo code FTL50 to get a great discount on privacy. That is priceless. We're talking about activism tactics. Some of the tactics of the activists here in the Keene area of New Hampshire. We're movers here as part of the Free State Project. You, Rich, Paul, Mark, myself, you, I guess you guys. Anyway, and there's long been critique about the tactics of the activism here. And now we've got a newer mover. His name is Ethan Glover. EthanGlover.biz is his website. And he is critiquing us, Rich. He says, what Ian Freeman and Rich Paul showed to the world is that in the Maggie Hassan video, Maggie Hassan being the governor that of New Hampshire that we cornered with a bunch of questions about a week ago, is that there are a couple of douchebags who like yelling at other people. I compared them to a group of drunk kids. They're dancing, having a good time, and they think they look awesome. In reality, it's a gaggle of idiots falling over one another, totally unaware of the outside world. Is that how you feel about yourself, Rich Paul?
No, I mean, I certainly was paying more attention to what I was saying than what was going on around me. I came close to bumping into a water cart a couple of times. I thought it was pretty good rhetoric.
I thought so, too. I thought what you had to say was very intelligent and thoughtful.
When I so what I immediately try to do is try to make this a third party situation. So I have seen presidential candidates, the president, and people like this get sort of you know, surprised, ambushed by people in the past. You see it like there'll be a dinner, you know, the Obama, I'm an important guy dinner.
Yeah.
And, you know, this, whatever the politician is, and, you know, some group will come in there and they'll attempt to shame the president or whomever. You know, I'm just, you know, it's happened to lots of politicians.
Sure.
Just Obama's coming to mind here. And, you know, what I generally find is the more I agree with the protesters, the point they're making, the more I feel like what they're doing is, you know, good or worthwhile.
The more
or
you
whatever.
Can forgive the interruption of the event or
right.
whatever.
Yeah, because, you know, it's certainly a breach of etiquette to do that. So, you know, you have to have some justification for a breach of etiquette.
Sure.
And, you know, the justification in my case is, in our case, is billions of dollars wasted, hundreds of thousands of lives ruined, disrupted, people killed, dogs shot, doors kicked down, phones tapped, civil liberties lost. So,
yeah.
I mean, that seems like an important issue to me.
Well, that and
worth
not,
a breach of etiquette.
Not only that, but the etiquette was also tried through the standard mode previously. So I have called Maggie Hassan's office under the auspices of being in the media and being on a, you know, nationally syndicated radio show, and have left multiple messages with her press secretary saying, hey, I'd like to talk to Maggie, I'd like to get her on the show, would like to, you know, have a conversation with her about whatever the issue happened to be, in this case, decriminalization. I've certainly called on that more than once, and I've never gotten a call back. I can't even get a call back from the press secretary. Now,
yeah,
that's very rude.
Yeah, you're the, you know, the host of a nationally syndicated radio program,
yeah,
and the fact that you can't get a call back shows the interest level that they have with communicating with you. Certainly you're a biased for you know, member of the press, but to some extent
everyone in the press is biased.
Everyone outside the press is biased too.
Yeah.
Free Talk Live, so, certainly more biased than most. I mean, you're not really a journalist, right? Like, you're a commentator.
That's right.
But it's, you know, like, we know that Maggie Hassan is not interested in talking to people that she doesn't feel are going to give her, you know, show her in a particularly positive light.
Right.
And
so all the standard rules go out the window as far as speaking to this woman.
Right. And I would agree with you. Now, admittedly, when that's the people who are watching the video don't. You know, don't really have, aren't privy to that information.
Mm-hmm.
They don't know you're necessarily the host of a nationally syndicated radio
fine.
Program. They don't know that you've attempted to communicate
I
with
I could
the
have
lady.
Put that information at the front of the video, but it didn't seem important.
I like the idea of having some opening explanation at the beginning of a video of, you know, this is what you're about to see, and mm-hmm. this is the issue we were talking about.
Sometimes I do, to some extent, and I did put an opening voiceover when I was describing what we were kind of doing there, but I didn't give a whole history of all the attempts I've attempted to, the times I've tried to contact her. That's just not relevant. I didn't feel that was that relevant to this. And plus, when you're doing a video, you also want to get through any kind of setup as quickly as possible so you can get to the payoff as quickly
right.
as possible, because you don't want a long, long video.
Sure.
That people will tune out of. So there's a tough
True.
Balancing act that goes on with that.
I guess if you're going to tack on much detail, you'd probably want to do it at the end of the video.
It just depends. But yeah, that's probably not so bad idea.
So, you know, going back to the idea that I've seen these ambush protests in the past, what I generally find is that the more I agree with the protesters, the more that I, you know, the more I like what they're talking about. And in this case, you have both a marijuana issue and a Common Core issue.
That's
so
right.
You're going to have most of the marijuana people like, yeah. Yeah, you know, the ones, because most people are disenfranchised from the government, and Governor Hassan just makes sure you're that much more disenfranchised.
Right.
She has no intention of talking to you, the little people.
Yeah, she'll only talk to the police. She loves them.
When you want to talk to a politician, you may get a chance to ask them a question, but you'll never get a follow-up question.
Yeah.
Excuse me, Governor Hassan, how many police need to die in order for you to stop continuing the war on drugs? Well, I think the war on drugs is, it's terrible what it's done to our young people. That you won't even answer the question
right.
because politicians don't answer the question. We are completely disenfranchised, and that's why people, you know, I don't think that they have that big of a problem with these ambush questions.
Well, the people unless who love the state have a problem with it.
Unless they truly support the politician or their position.
Or they support the idea of the state, right? Which would be supporting their position. 855-450-FREE. You're supposed to respect politicians, right?
In the U.S. alone, a home invasion occurs every 13 seconds. On top of that, the average response time for 911 is over 15 minutes. That just won't cut it. Don't allow yourself or the important people in your life to be victims. When seconds matter, don't be caught stumbling for your firearm. Get the protection you deserve. Get yourself a hidden holster from HiddenHolster.com. It's the original hidden holster. The hidden holster is quick, easy, and convenient. It's versatile enough for the home, workplace, or virtually anywhere else you might need it. Have peace of mind with your firearm close by at all times. Go to HiddenHolster.com. That's HiddenHolster.com. If you own a firearm, you need a hidden holster. Your protection matters, and self-defense is the best defense. Go to HiddenHolster.com. That's HiddenHolster.com. The original hidden holster.
Free Talk Live.
I wouldn't snitch them out. I would report them to the police.
Right.
Okay, now
call it what you want, sir.
Now, many states have laws about carrying firearms, even though their constitutions say that it's legal for everyone to own a firearm.
Like New York State.
There's no way to ban it. Would you snitch out somebody that you knew had a firearm?
If they had it illegally, I wouldn't snitch them out. I would report them.
Right.
I got to say, you're a bad American, Ken.
Yeah. I think you're a scumbag, Ken.
You're a communist.
I'm
a communist because I want people to be able to carry guns like the Second Amendment says.
He'd snitch on the person and then the cops would come and infringe it for him.
Felons out there carrying guns at will?
I'm a convicted felon. Do you think I shouldn't be able to protect my wife from an intruder?
I don't think you should have a gun.
How am I going to protect myself if the guy has a gun?
There are many other ways to protect yourself than not having a gun.
You should call the cops, Mark, like any good citizen.
That way the cops can come clean up my corpse after it's all over, right?
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Stouffer's, helping bring your family together with wholesome dinner options, even on the busiest of nights. Find dinner table ideas to bring your family together at letsfixdinner.com. To get kids involved in dinner time conversation, ask specific questions, not broad ones. Instead of what happened today at school, try what was the best thing that happened today. The more specific you are, the more they'll have to say. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
I've been told no in many different ways.
I give you an order and you're going to obey it.
Who told you to go this way?
You can't do that and you have to leave here.
You cannot bring Simon to their rally.
Walk with me.
Well, I'm comfortable here, actually.
Whoa, excuse me.
Who do you think
excuse
you are?
Excuse me.
There is no video or audio allowed in this office.
No, I have work today. This is...
You ain't going to make...
Wait
a minute. Now.
Wait a minute.
Hey! Oh my God! Unbelievable!
Why are you running?
Because you scared me.
What am I being detained for?
You're being served.
What is this?
You're being served.
What is this?
Bureaucrats have a funny way of telling people no.
That's the sound of the men working on the chain.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is Free Talk Live. Join us here on the radio, toll free at 855-450-FREE. We're talking tactics, different styles of activism. Some of it rubs people the wrong way. I think it's generally the case that any activism will rub someone the wrong way.
Absolutely.
No matter how designed to be unoffensive as it is in advance, someone is bound to be offended, at least if you're having an effect. You know, you can go out in the middle of nowhere and hold a sign and no one will know. and then no one will care. So you have to have some sort of an impact for someone to care enough to hate what you're doing, or to at the very least dislike it.
But there's we read one study one time, and I don't know that there are any studies that I've ever seen otherwise, but people generally dislike activists.
Sure.
You know, it's just like, get a job.
People don't like to have their daily routine broken up by anything unexpected. So, you know, if it's somebody on the side of the road with a sign waving at them, get a job! You know, they'll yell at them, they'll say something, they'll flip them the bird or whatever. Even if they don't, you know, in a lot of cases, they don't even know what the protest is about, and they'll drive by and yell, get a job. I've been at every protest I've ever been at. It doesn't even matter what the issue is. People will yell that phrase.
And
so
I guess
that's an indicator that they hate activism.
Well, what they're saying, I guess, to some extent is that, look, I don't have time in my life to stand up for things that I believe strongly in. And
if
so,
they believe strongly
in. Because I have to watch TV tonight.
Yeah, shame on you for taking the time to get involved in your community. I'm not exactly sure what they're saying, but I can tell you that what I find most interesting is I've gone out to the peace vigils here in Keene, New Hampshire.
Yep, I've been yelled at there.
And it's some of the one of the longest running peace vigils in the world on a weekly basis. It's set up by veterans of foreign, you know, veterans of foreign wars or whatever. These guys that have gotten together, not the organization BFW, but these vets. And people will drive by. People will be angry at the peace protesters because they have this idea that the peace protesters are somehow pacifists or something like that.
Mm.
And I mean, they're yelling things at, in one case, my a friend of mine who is a World War II vet. You know, like literally the people that they would be saying, hey, look back at the World War II vets. What would they think if they saw this? Well, one of them's sitting right here. Why don't you take 1 second to get some kind of knowledge about that which of which you speak, you ignoramus? But people don't. I mean, they operate entirely on emotion. I don't think we can change that. I think we need to accept it. But what we also need to look at is that, you know, when protests are done on video, people have a different reaction to them. Many times the people who are going to see the video are people that are going to be more likely to support it. You know, people that dislike protesters generally are less likely to watch a video about protesters. So I think that when you see, like, the president has a 47% approval rating, right?
Okay, I'll take your word for it.
And I've seen Congress as low as 9% for their approval rating.
Yep.
When you see these people ambushed, the people who disapprove of them tend to not be so upset when they see these ambush interviews go on.
As you'd expect.
So I tend to think when you're talking about Governor Hassan, let's just say that her approval rating is something like 47% too.
She's been reelected.
She has, but she doesn't have the approval rating that the previous Democratic governor had, who was liked by both Republicans and Democrats. She is much more a partisan Democrat, and the truly liberal types that might vote for her because she's a Democrat may dislike her because she's not great on environmental issues or on cannabis or a variety of other things. So she really has this smaller margin, let's call it 25% of the population, are going to be like, you need to respect the governor. I can't believe you had to do this at the college students at this time. And there's not a college student other than like the class president who's trying to get you people out of there. But there's no real college student who's being upset by this. It's not even near them.
So I want to continue here with the story from Ethan Glover and his critique. He does have something nice to say. I'll get to that in a moment. But I also want to let you know about ExpressCoin.com, which is where you can go to get cryptocurrencies like Bitcoin, Litecoin, and Dogecoin. It's fast, safe, easy, and inexpensive. They're a licensed money services business, and whether you're in the U.S. or Canada, they can help you. You can get your cryptocurrency with money order or check by starting at ExpressCoin.com. You can even download their app for your smartphone if you'd like, ExpressCoin.com. Don't forget to use coupon code FTL, and you'll get up to $40 worth of cryptocurrency with no transfer fee at all when you use coupon code FTL over at ExpressCoin.com. So go get your Bitcoin at ExpressCoin.com with code FTL. Now, Ethan says, after likening Rich Paul, you and I, to drunken college students totally unaware of the outside world and suggesting that other people consider us to be douchebags who like yelling at people.
Some people do.
Ethan does say, I don't speak here from a place of anger, frustration, or cynicism. I find Rich and Ian to be good people who've done a lot of good. They've made more mistakes than me in their activism because they've done more. as a result of those mistakes.
Probably a lot more would be my guess. I mean, I don't know anything about Ethan's activism.
He's
but
relatively young, so there's a good chance we've done
right.
more.
You have done, you too, Ian, you specifically, and Rich Paul, you know, certainly up there, you guys have a lot of experience in doing activism. Well, this is one of the things that I think to myself when I critique the activism of others is that at the very least, I need to get out and do my own. I do activism in the sense that I sell radio ads and keep the keep Free Talk Live running. Mm-hmm. And Free Talk Live is a really good place from which to stand to preach. But, you know, I also go and do the political thing. I'm a delegate for the state convention and a few other things. And some of the reasons that I do that is in order to be able to critique other people's activism with some modicum of, knowing that I've done these things myself.
Yeah, it's true. I mean, when I hear somebody like Dave Ridley from RidleyReport.com giving a critique of something that I've done, it weighs a lot heavier with me than some random YouTube commenter, right? Because Dave, he's got his street cred. He's been out there. He's been put in handcuffs for his activism. He's an activist who I highly respect. And he's got, you know, a perspective that is valuable. So that's something that I want to hear. And I certainly have taken Dave's critiques to heart in some cases. In some cases, he's been totally wrong. But that's just how things go. So Ethan continues, he says, as a result of those mistakes, at least the ones they've recognized, they know more about what they're doing. I speak here with a feeling of justice that says I've got something to say and I've got friends who need to hear it. There will always be something of a balance between types of activism. People often compare Martin Luther King and Malcolm X, referring to them as having a yin and yang dynamic. I'm aware that my rejection of the Malcolm X aggressive style may be evidence of my falling into the trap of thinking, if we only did it my way. However, with that in mind, I believe a precise, data-driven approach to changing things for the better can only be beneficial. I don't aim to tell anyone what to do. I only aim to present some generalities and theories applicable to your own style of doing good for the world.
Yeah, I think this is really valid stuff to say is that, look, we need to get some metrics going here, see what works and see what doesn't work. It's not like this has never been proposed before. The difficulty is when you're doing activism, is you don't know necessarily what works and what doesn't work. I mean,
like I said, it depends who you ask.
Exactly.
Yeah, I was going to say that, you know, Dave Ridley certainly has a valuable opinion on activism, but he isn't our target audience by definition.
No, that's true.
You know, he's another activist, so it's, you know, I do like hearing criticism from the general public. And, you know, hearing what they have to say, how I could do things differently. So, like at one point I got feedback that when I was on the megaphone at the 420 rally, I was swearing too much and that was bothering some people. And I said, well, you know, that really doesn't add anything useful to my message. It's like an exclamation point and I can do that in other ways. So I tried to clean that particular aspect up, you know.
Right. A lot of the critique that we've received on this most recent episode of confronting the governor at a commencement for Keene State College has been that we were somehow disrupting the ceremony. And to me, that is not what happened at all, right? Because we made a specific effort to not disrupt the ceremony. The ceremony was going on in a very large stage area in an open kind of a quad or whatever they call it, where, you know, kind of a grassy field. Big stage had been set up. There was the rows of seating for the graduates up front, and behind that, all the family members. So literally thousands of people were there. But Maggie Hassan was far away from all that. She was at the very back of the line of the procession.
You could have been a mile away, and if somebody would have seen it, they'd be like, this is the college student special day!
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, you know, there's no making some of these people happy.
Well,
so
yes, there is.
Well,
die. Go away. Right. Blow into particles.
They'll still be angry about something. More coming up. This is Free Talk Live.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online, and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
If the IRS has garnished your paycheck or seized money from your bank account, you need to get professional tax help now. Fast action is required to put a halt to these aggressive IRS collection tactics. You can count on the knowledgeable team of tax professionals at Wall & Associates. With over 30 years of experience, Wall & Associates has settled the tax problems of thousands of taxpayers for a small fraction of what they owed. For a free face-to-face consultation, call 1-800-425-4610 to put a wall between you and the IRS. 1-800-425-4610 or look for us on the web at wallandassociates.net. We solve tax problems. If you hire Wall & Associates today, you'll never have to talk to the IRS again. To stop the levies and seizures today, take action now. Call Wall & Associates at 1-800-425-4610. Wall & Associates. 1-800-425-4610. Based on actual cases, results may vary. Not a solicitation for legal services.
Here's a breaking medical legal alert. Attention, users of the diabetes drug Actos. If you or a loved one has taken Actos, then developed bladder cancer, or if a loved one has died from bladder cancer after taking Actos, you may be entitled to significant financial compensation from the pharmaceutical giants who made these drugs. Our experienced attorneys are dedicated to help you get the money you're entitled to, but time may be running out on this opportunity. So you must call today. The information is free. There are no fees unless we win your case. If you or a loved one has developed bladder cancer or something worse after taking the diabetes drug Actos, call right now and learn your legal rights. This is an advertisement not valid in all states. I am a paid non-attorney spokesperson. Call the Tort Attorneys 24/7 right now. 800-430-7924. 800-430-7924. That's 800-430-7924.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolf. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can join us here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. We're talking about activism tactics. It's bound that activism is going to upset people. That's just the nature of the beast. But how do you determine whether or not what you've done as activism is successful? What are the metrics that you use? Is there any way to really figure this out? Ethan Glover has some suggestions he's going to give us here in a moment because he's been fairly critical, Rich Paul, of you and I in a recent bit of activism we did where we cornered the New Hampshire governor on a bunch of marijuana or decriminalization-related questions. Plus, coming up when we get a chance, what appears to be a good court decision out of the Supreme Court regarding taxes in some states. We'll share that with you, and you're welcome to comment here. We've got Skype as well, at Skype username lrn.fm. Also, I meant to talk about this a little bit last night, and we just ran out of time, and I didn't get a chance to really say what I think should have been said about the African Satellite Fundraiser, which we've been doing over the last 2 months here on Free Talk Live. We had our signal over most of Africa for a couple of years, actually, for free.
from our satellite provider. We're on over North and Central America as well on what's called free-to-air, which means that people with a cheap receiver and a cheap dish can receive our content and pay nothing monthly for it. So free-to-air meaning no cost monthly for the users to receive hundreds of channels of television and radio. And most of these channels are international. They're, you know, a bunch of religious channels. There's foreign language channels, lots of foreign language channels, Arabic and, you know, all kinds of stuff. And so it's very eclectic. And the reason I'm up there, the reason I put our signal up there in Free Talk Live and LRN.FM, all the great shows there, is because I know there are people listening to free-to-air that don't have internet access. And this is a way to get the ideas of freedom into those people's minds, especially in a place like Africa, where a lot of people don't have internet access.
There's less to consume on these channels. They're free, so people put up the satellite dishes to be able to listen and view them.
Especially in poor countries where there is no such thing as cable TV.
Right, they're not paying $75 a month for cable out there in Africa, because that would feed you for a year.
Right.
So they consume this stuff, and there's not that much out there. That, you know, if you want to listen to religious stuff, there's a lot of that.
Yes.
And but if you're looking for English language, things that are non-religious, maybe that are talking issues and that kind of thing, there's not much. And that's why Free Talk Live, you know, imagine that in many ways that we can represent the U.S. to these people in a way that, you know, it's not getting represented, you know, to them at all.
Yeah, that's true. We've actually talked to a caller from Cameroon, Africa. His name's Akko, and he explained to us that it was really eye-opening to hear that the United States has problems, because they had, you know, the belief system that everything was great and everything was totally free here, and, you know, there's a certain propaganda message that gets out there about the U.S., and they had never heard anything contrary to that. So hearing that for the first time from Free Talk Live and the other shows on LRN.FM was quite an experience.
True, although there is a big difference. I mean, I would much rather be in America than anywhere in Africa.
I would prefer not to live in Cameroon as well. There's no doubt about that. But it was an important perspective for those folks over there to hear. True. That, you know, we've got problems with our government too, right? Mm-hmm. So anyway, the
reason that, you know, that if terrorists did the work on 9/11 and blew up the World Trade Center, it's because they believe that the American people are the American government.
Yeah.
And so therefore they are guilty of whatever the U.S. government has done. And I don't think that's exactly the case.
So we were on over Africa. We got response from African listeners who were able to reach out to us and let us know they were listening to that signal. And then in February of this year, the signal was pulled from the air. That's because we were being given it for free. And the free ride was only supposed to last 2 months. The free ride lasted more than 2 years. So I'm really grateful for all the free airtime that we got. And I wanted to move ahead and get back on that satellite, get back on over Africa. And it's going to cost us this time. So we did a fundraiser over the last 60 days. It was a 2-month-long Indiegogo fundraiser. I'd never done anything like that before, ever. We took a lot of time to really kind of tweak it as much as possible, make sure to get the video pitch right, get the written pitch right, you know, to try to make this as an accessible and shareable thing as we could. And ultimately, we didn't meet the goal of $22,000, but I'm still calling this a success. And allow me to explain briefly why I consider it a success, even though we didn't meet the goal. Well, the $22,000 was what I would call shooting for the moon, meaning that, you know, you shoot for the moon, maybe you'll get over the fence, that kind of thing, right? Like
you feel like you got over the fence.
I feel like we definitely got over the fence. And so if you look at, you break it down, the $22,000 was 3 years worth of satellite broadcasting, because it's a 3-year agreement typically when you get into this. And I had calculated that based on what I believe the highest possible rate would be from the satellite provider. So they had quoted me a number, and realistically, the number that we actually go with, whatever the final negotiated price is going to be lower than that. But I wanted to make sure I put the biggest number possible on there so we could shoot for that in case that's what it ended up being. Well, if you do the division, you divide 22,000 by 3, you get about $7,200, basically. It was $600 a month, so 600 times 12, actually. So you get $7,200, which is about a third of $22,000. And we raised in that 60-day time frame. There was a peak at the first 2 weeks, and then a peak in the last week. We raised about $5,000 and about one Bitcoin. So it's about $200 worth of Bitcoin. So we raised $5,000, which is the super, that's, you know, pretty much most of the first year's worth of broadcasting. So I figured, you know, we're going to move forward with this, even though we didn't make the official goal, because we, at the very least, are going to easily cover the first year. And I suspect I've got my offer in with the satellite provider. I'm hoping to get them to give me less than $500 or $5,000 for a year. I don't know if they will or not, but even if they don't, you know, the Shire Free Church will kick in the difference and we'll make this happen. Really, what this fundraiser for me was, is I wanted to see if you, the listener, actually value this outreach like I do, because I think it's really important. And Mark, you've been a skeptic of it for a long time.
Yeah, I'm skeptical. I mean, just I'm unsure, I think, is probably the best way. I'm not sure what the value is. You know, I don't know how
are these ideas valuable?
They are.
Okay, would it be valuable to reach people with those ideas?
We don't know how many people are listening. We have no way.
You never know how many people are listening, even to a radio station.
You get more metrics from, you know, U.S. radio stations than you get from African free-to-air satellites.
You can also pay for airtime on one radio station, Mark, and, you know, be paying more money than you'd pay to be on this African satellite.
Absolutely.
And we have
I have sold radio actually, you know, by the hour to people, and I have sold it at higher rates in one market than the entire continent of Africa.
And we have had people contact us from Africa letting us know they're listening. And you know that when people contact you, they're only a percentage of the actual number of people who are listening, right?
Right.
We don't know what the percentage is, but I suspect it's less than 1%. So at the very least, we know there are people out there and we know these ideas are powerful. And if we can reach them for a few hundred bucks a month, that seems well worth the effort. And so part of the fundraising idea was to see, well, do people agree with me on this? You know, do they find value in this? Are they willing to back this with their money as well? I'm willing to back it with, you know, the money that I've contributed to the Shire Free Church. But are they willing to back it? And the answer to me was yes. You know, we had 56 contributions come in over that 60-day time frame. By no means was this a barn buster kind of fundraiser. I mean, the video was only watched 500 times that I made. The number of people who went to the page, because you can use Google Analytics to look at your Indiegogo statistics, basically. So I looked, and you know, there were only around 400 or 500 people. I think it was close to 500 that actually ever even looked at the fundraising page. So I figure if you get a 10% conversion rate, you know, 500 people are looking and 56 of them contributed, I consider 10% to be very, very good. You know, Mark, if you call 100 potential prospects for radio advertising, if you get one to buy, that's decent, right? Like,
well, I don't do cold calling in that same traditional
but generally,
sense. I don't have the time
sales,
for
right?
that crap. I don't know. I'd say 1 out of 10 is what I would be looking for. But it's completely different when you're communicating with somebody via voice. They know a person's on the other end of the line than when you're dealing with a web page. There's no way to sort of compare mailers to you know, voice to knocking, you know, not walking into a business and getting the decision maker right there.
I just don't go into these things with high expectations. If I get 1%, I think, well, you know, we did all right. If I get 10%, I think, wow, that's pretty good. Like 1 out of 10 people going ahead and clicking contribute. So I feel like, you know, we pretty much covered the first year of satellite coverage in Africa, and there was a decent amount of people who looked at this, who went ahead and did this. I feel like from all those metrics, it was a very successful fundraiser. So thank you to everyone who took the time. We had a contribution as low as $1 and as high as, I think, $1,800. So there were some very, very generous people who stepped forward, and they all did it without any real, like, you know, junky freebie packages, you know, which I didn't want to do. I didn't want to, like, give away a bunch of T-shirts and crap like that. Because
Free Talk Live
somebody.
Doesn't really sell anything.
Right, because then you have to pay somebody to fulfill all those orders, and then there's customer service issues. And so we're sending out some bumper stickers to some folks, and there's a list of names, a thank you list on our satellite page at sat.lrn.fm, and the African satellite thing's going to move forward. I just have to enter into an agreement with the provider at this point, so negotiations are commencing. We'll talk more about tactics and the Supreme Court coming up.
Well, I did it. I finally left the empire behind. And now that I'm safely settled in Chile, I'm gathering with others like me to build a new community called Fort Galt. Fort Galt is designed to be the ideal home base for professionals and their families to live and work in peace. If you're ready to ditch the superstate and bring your business to freer lands, visit us online at fortgalt.com. That's fortgalt.com.
Thank you. New Hampshire is under quarantine as walking corpses devour the flesh of the living. Max is 11 years old and surviving alone. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the dead swarm his home. Now he must apply his porcupine Freedom Scouts training to improvise his escape. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook, read reviews on Amazon, or read Chapter 1 at SurvivorMax.com.
If you want to move to the free state, and you're looking for some real estate.
Oof, I think we've all had enough of that jingle, don't you? If you're going to invest in property in New Hampshire, it just makes sense to support a liberty-friendly realtor. Call Mark Warden of Team Porcupine Real Estate for investment property or rentals in the Free State, or visit his website. Come on, you know it.
PorcupineRealEstate.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Tuesday, May 19th, 2015. Silver is trading at $17.53 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,221 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $234. Antiwar.com reports the authorization for use of military force for the war against the Islamic State, which has been raging for 9 months now, has still not been brought to a vote, and the recent indications are it probably never will be. Representative Adam Schiff of California said the snag is there is no real political will or interest in doing this, saying no vote on the war would be a terrible precedent. Yet that seems to be where things are headed, as the White House unveiled its proposed AUMF bill and quickly alienated most of the public by saying it was deliberately vague to allow them to expand the war at will. In the lead up to last November's election, there was little interest in a politically volatile vote, and now that the war has been going on so long, most of the Republican leadership, which supports the war at any rate, seems to see no need to put anything on paper. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. UPI reports President Obama announced federal standards to improve trust between police and communities and a ban on some types of military equipment for local police agencies. Obama spoke on the measures Monday in Camden, New Jersey, a city that has struggled with one of the country's highest violent crime rates. A blueprint for improved community policing was announced that will help cities and towns develop policing strategies that work best for building trust between law enforcement and the communities they serve while enhancing public safety. Obama pointed to work Camden has done to grow trust between the city's residents and its police force and a subsequent drop in violent crime, murder, and open-air drug markets. The White House will attempt to create improved methods of using data and technologies in ways to build community trust and reduce unnecessary uses of force. The Department of Justice recently announced a new program that will help law enforcement agencies implement the use of body-worn cameras on officers, which will be further supported by the White House. Tools cities can utilize will be presented as part of the Task Force on 21st Century Policing program that can be used to build and maintain the all-important trust between the law enforcement officers and the communities they have sworn to serve and protect. Meanwhile, the White House announced a list of items that are banned from being acquired by local police under select federal programs. The list
list includes tracked armored vehicles, weaponized aircrafts and vehicles, bayonets, grenade launchers, and large caliber firearms. During his speech in Camden, Obama said, "We've seen how militarized gear sometimes gives people a feeling like they're an occupying force as opposed to part of a community they're there to protect. Some equipment made for the battlefield is not appropriate for local police departments." Under more rigorous control, law enforcement agencies will still be able to acquire armored vehicles, tactical vehicles, riot gear, and specialized firearms and ammunition. In Survivor Max by Davi Barker, 11-year-old Max must survive the zombie apocalypse alone in New Hampshire. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the lame brains swarm his home searching for living flesh. Max must apply his porcupine Freedom Scouts training to plan his escape, but first he must prove that he's too smart to die. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook and Amazon, or read Chapter 1 free at SurvivorMax.com. Reuters reports four passengers on the Amtrak commuter train that derailed in Philadelphia last week filed a federal lawsuit on Monday against the rail service. The lawsuit filed in Philadelphia cited serious and disabling injuries from the May 12th derailment that killed eight people and injured more than 200 others. Nearly a week after the derailment, it remains a mystery what caused the train to accelerate from 70 miles per hour to 106 miles per hour in a minute before the crash. Authorities have not yet ruled out equipment malfunction, human error, or other possible reasons for the train gaining speed so rapidly. This lawsuit appears to be the first filed by a non-employee of Amtrak. Last week, an Amtrak employee who was riding the train as a passenger filed the first lawsuit, citing a brain injury he suffered in the crash. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Here is the Onion Week in Review, Transportation Edition. In Albany, a Greyhound bus crash claimed 30 miserable lives Tuesday, finally putting over two dozen deadbeat fathers, penniless drug addicts, and hapless bastards out of their misery. Emergency crews at the scene of the merciful accident described the sea of fast food bags, candy bar wrappers, and losing lottery tickets surrounding the crash site as utterly tragic, adding that the scorched corpses inside the bus were, quote, only slightly more lifeless than before the deadly accident.
Evidence suggests that most of the victims suffered during the crash, and for many years before they even boarded the bus. All I can say is, thank God no one made it.
Al-Qaeda is refusing to carry out any further terrorist attacks until the U.S. mass transportation infrastructure is drastically improved, calling the country's roads and bridges a, quote, travesty, unbecoming of a developed first world nation.
We want to turn your bridges into rubble, but if we took credit for making them collapse, no one would ever believe us.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. You can dial in toll-free here. 855-450-FREE is our number. That's 855-450-3733. In studio tonight, you've got me, Ian.
Rich Paul.
And Mark.
Rich Paul is here courtesy of the Church of the Invisible Hand. Rich, that is one of the projects that you're involved in right now. You've got actually a few of them going on, including the Union of Unemployed People?
Yeah, the Union of Unemployed People, the 420 Foundation, those are the big ones. And those are all ministries of the church. But
which you can access all of those by going to your fundraising page, which is richpaul.freekeen.com.
It's true.
And you've got links there to all of your projects, as well as ways to support you directly.
And also videos of some of my activism. So, you know, if you're not sure if you're going to like it or not, watch the videos and find out. Let me know.
So our toll-free number tonight is 855-450-FREE. We have been talking about your activism, Rich, and mine as well, in the context of an article critiquing it from Ethan Glover, who is a relatively new mover to New Hampshire. He lives in the Keene area. He lives in a town just south of the Keene zone. And he has been a little critical of some of the approaches, like the one where you and I corner the governor of New Hampshire at a commencement event for the Keene State College, their graduation. Now, to point out, make sure it's very clear, and if, in case you haven't watched the video, it should be clear when you watch the video, but if you haven't watched the video, you might have only heard rumors about it. We don't disrupt the actual commencement. we pepper her with questions because she's at the very end of a very long line of students who are mostly waiting to try to get into this commencement. In fact, there weren't even really any students nearby her with the exception of like the class valedictorian who was standing right next to her. Besides that, she was surrounded with
a bunch. Sucking up.
Right. We were gone before commencement commenced.
Exactly. We cut out of there as she started to enter the actual area where the commencement was to take place, where all the families were waiting and the students were there and all that. So we were very cognizant of where we were and not wanting to disrupt the reason why all those people were there. We only wanted to disrupt Maggie Hassan's day, and I feel like we were very successful in doing that. But Ethan wants to get into some suggestions, what he believes could be what he calls a precise, data-driven approach to determine whether or not your activism is effective. And so I want to hear what he has to say here. He says, what are the results? He says, we'll start with the easiest of examples. Arguing with strangers on the internet. Which, by the way, I don't really consider that to be activism.
A lot of people seem to. Keyboard activists, you know, people that go on Facebook and snipe in comments and
I've done my share of arguing on the internet, no doubt about it.
I would call it activism
if you're doing it for a particular purpose. It's like I will go in as the Union of Unemployed People's page and I will comment on other pages, and what I'm looking for is to get more likes for my organization to continue getting the message out. But then that's followed by, when I have an event, those are the people that find out about the event. So it's a form of promotion
for me. More of a marketing,
me.
I guess. More of marketing than anything.
You know,
right?
Certainly if you're putting out a serious philosophical blog, that I would also call activism, like something that Chris Cantwell does or something that Stefan Molyneux does. I consider that to be activism, although it's not out in the streets. But, you know, I had a debate one year with Matt Simon at Porkfest when it was supposed to be a debate about civil disobedience versus in-system activism. And I got lucky. He went first and he went and listed all the reasons that, you know, you should do this and not that. And when it came to my turn, my response was, well, do it all. Do
right.
Whatever kind of activism you want to do. And I think it's good. Not only I think it was good that we did the activism, but I think it's also good that there are people out there criticizing it, because people who, you know, may be attracted to our movement but put off by our tactics can then read that and say, oh, there are people in this movement that I can talk to.
Yeah, I agree.
You know, and at the same time, you know, there's different activists have different audiences, you know, and what my audience likes, your audience or Chris Cantwell's audience might not like, okay? But that's okay if I'm reaching somebody.
Well, yeah, I agree. And I think that we do need to have different approaches, and I personally am willing to do pretty much whatever it takes. You know, I'll do politics, I'll do civil disobedience, I'll create media, and, you know, I think that multiple approaches is very important. But at the same time, generally, we're not the ones downing those other approaches. It's very frequently certain people who they believe in sort of like, let's say, totally inside the system approaches who seem like they spend an inordinate amount of time on the attack against people who have a different set of tactics.
Well, there's sort of some different groups out there as, people that believe that you should only do inside the system activism. And if you do outside the system activism, you are sort of sullying the name of the inside the system activist.
And technically, this is inside the system, right? Because we're talking to the governor.
There are people out there that believe that if you do any kind of inside the system activism, I believe Ethan Glover is one of them, any kind of inside the system activism, that you then sanctify the system. You promote the system itself. And so therefore, you know, all of that is evil, essentially.
Well, there are also those who believe that if you do inside the system activism, that you have to bow down to the system, that you have to kiss the ring, you have to be very worshipful towards it and very respectful towards it, which is why, even though when we're trying to contact the governor, that's technically inside the system, we're not doing it in the traditional manner that is expected, which is, of course, to entreat and to beg and to write letters and things like that. We were just letting her know how we felt, and some people were uncomfortable about that. But let's get into some of his suggestions here. He says, let's start with looking at, talking to people on the internet. Arguing with strangers on the internet, he says, a precise data-driven approach online is easy. If you're in the habit of trying to explain your political ideas to people online, take note of who is really paying attention. What are the results of talking to communists on groups like Still Laughing at Anarcho-Capitalism or liberals on Being Liberal? Oftentimes, I see others hoping to jump into a ring with a dozen hungry lions and expect to tame them all at once. When they find they've bitten off more than they can chew and get frustrated, they turn to aggressive language and call it trolling as a joke. Instead of recognizing a failure, they move the goalpost to something useless and stubbornly continue the wasteful behavior. On this one, I got to agree with Ethan.
Yeah.
I think that arguing online is nothing more than a fun pastime, and it's generally a bad way to pass your time if you have more productive things that you should be doing.
And the problem is you can't really communicate with somebody online.
No.
And he's right. When you talk about like 20 hungry lions, that's a really great analogy.
You can't get someone to address a point online.
No, so rarely. I mean, I've had my opinion changed a couple of times reading stuff online, but it's rare, and I like to think of myself as open-minded. So if the very fact that I can, that it has happened rarely to me, I can only imagine what it is for people that I consider to be not as open-minded as I. I consider myself to be above the mean as far as open-mindedness goes. I watch it all the time when I try to address things with people. They move. You address their point, you make it abundantly clear, and then they pick one tiny thing out of what you said and make that the new issue.
Right. Zero in on that. And
wait
then...
a second. You just ignored everything I addressed here. I proved that you have a mistaken point of view, that you're ignorant on this issue, and bam, you're like, no.
When I argue with somebody online, I'm generally not expecting that person to be convinced, because generally I argue with zealots for some particular school of thought. And so what I'm looking to do is to convince the people reading.
That's correct. If that's the most you can hope from an argument, you can never expect the opponent to all of a sudden see the light and thank you, Mark, for showing me the true path.
Hallelujah.
That's just not going to happen. But yeah, I agree with you, Rich. It's the people who are observing quietly, that are reading that conversation. That's who it really makes a difference to. If you want to say that arguing online is in any way productive, it would be with those people, I would say.
And that frustrates me about that, and is that we have a very popular Facebook page where lots of people will chime in. But how many people actually read through comments and get convinced? I would imagine it's in the dozens on a big thread, maybe the hundreds. Here on none of these people are brave enough to pick up the phone and call us at 855-450-FREE and up their point and get out to tens of thousands of people on Free Talk Live.
Well, they'd also have to have a conversation with us at that point. More coming up. It's Free Talk Live. They wouldn't be able to ignore stuff as easily.
Attention, business owners. Do you know the three most critical letters in business?
CEO?
MBA?
Nope. Here's a hint. These three little letters can make the difference between making a fortune and losing everything.
ROI?
The answer is INC, as in incorporation. Because if you're not incorporated and someone sues your business, you can lose it all. Your home, your car, even your life savings. That's why Incorporate.com is now giving away a free incorporation guide to all business owners, so you can incorporate in just 10 minutes. Protect your home. Protect your car. Protect your life savings. Call 1-800-941-1029 for your free 10-minute incorporation guide from Incorporate.com. They don't provide legal or financial advice. They just make incorporating or forming an LLC quick and easy. Get the three little letters that can mean the difference between making a fortune and losing everything. For your free guide, call 1-800-941-1029. That's 1-800-941-1029.
Making the right decisions is a challenge to investors. Are we going to see economic growth slide into a recession or, at worst, depression? Hi, Ted Anderson from Midas Resources. We all know when a company acts irresponsibly, divesting ourselves in a move towards safety is prudent. When the market becomes volatile, U.S. treasuries are a safe haven. But what do you do when the U.S. government overextends itself and spends beyond its means? Many investors are turning toward gold as a common-sense alternative to traditional paper for investments. Midas Resources has put together a powerful book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, discussing costs, benefits, risks, featuring full-color illustrations, weights, and measures. The book is free and can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. Paper investments are dwarfed by gold's 6,000-year history. Discover how gold may be right for you and your IRA by calling 800-686-2237. Whether buying or it's time for you to sell, the book is free. Call 800-686-2237.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at lrn.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at lrn.fm. That's lrn.fm.
Are you tired of governments murdering people around the world? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin cannot be inflated or controlled by any government. By using their money, you are helping the state. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available now. Learn it, use it, spread it. Get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. That's weusecoins.com.
Do you love Twitter? Make sure you favorite the LRN.FM Twitter account so you can receive our tweets at twitter.lrn.fm. That's twitter.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. You can join us here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. We're talking about activism tactics, which, of course, is always a controversial discussion because a lot of people disagree on what the right way to do this stuff is to try to change things. Because,
well, a lot of people don't want things to change at all, and they just throw in FUD.
Well, sorry, but change is inevitable. Something is going to change. Now, we would like things to change in a more peaceful direction.
The world's a better place because activists got out and did something at
Absolutely.
Some point in the past, and everybody agrees on it. You know, the people,
even though they piss people off.
The same folks that disagreed with Rosa Parks getting on the bus and refusing to move because it's just not nice to do that, the same folks today they don't like new different types of activism. I'm not saying every type of activism is Rosa Parks by any stretch of the imagination. That was well-planned activism. They, as I understand, the civil rights activists there chose to pass by a few other activists that attempt to do similar activism and really promoted Rosa Parks basically because she was an older woman. But she went to activism training. This was planned. This lady intended to do this, and she broke the normal social paradigm there, and a lot of people didn't like it.
So coming up, Mark, you're going to be in Las Vegas in July.
That's right, for the Freedom Fest event. It's called Discover the New American Dream. It's July the 8th through the 11th. Now, you want to arrive just a little early, so think of it as 7 to 11 in Vegas. It's at Planet Hollywood. It's going to be a lot of fun. This is the largest gathering of free minds in the world, and this one is even more epic than any that have come in the past because of the what they're calling the historic dream debate of the century. Paul Krugman versus Steve Moore. Steve Moore is the Wall Street Journal columnist and chief economist for the Heritage Foundation, and Krugman is the Nobel Prize-winning economist and New York Times columnist, and they're going to debate austerity versus stimulus, red state versus blue state, flat tax versus progressive tax. And this is only happening at Freedom Fest. I said in the last segment that I like to consider myself to be open-minded. That's one of the reasons I'm really excited about this debate. I want to see what Krugman says. I want to hear what he has to say, because I tend to be a fiscally conservative individual. I'm not going in there to watch Moore crush Krugman. I'm going in there to see what Krugman has to say, what the value is in the other side. So there's going to be lots of Liberty luminaries there, folks like John Mackey, the CEO of Whole Foods, Peter Thiel, Steve Wynn, Steve Forbes, Dinesh D'Souza, Grover Norquist, Justin Amash, Glenn Beck, George Gilder. It's a star-studded event, and it's going to be well worth the ticket price. Go there to freedomfest.com. When you buy your ticket, please click that you heard it on the radio. That is how they're rating whether or not Free Talk Live's ad's effective. And I would love to see you out there. It's going to be a lot of fun. Please come by and say hi. We'll be on Radio Row. It's freedomfest.com. Call toll free, 855-850-FREE. It's 855-850-FREE to register, or go to freedomfest.com. If you call them, be sure to mention Free Talk Live.
Let's go to your calls and thoughts. Carlos is in Florida. You're on Free Talk Live. Carlos.
Hey, guys. I just wanted to say I liked how you went after the governor up there. I just wish there would have been more of you. I mean, if people face her like that, it's going to make her uncomfortable. Maybe think about what she's doing more.
Yeah, I agree with you. I wish we had more people out there as well. It was, you know, in the middle of a Saturday afternoon, and obviously, you know, not everybody's interested in doing this sort of activism. So we're getting a subset of people who would be even willing to and able to come out and do this. But what really, not only would have been nice to have more people there, we had three. So it was Rich, myself, and a guy named Ed. So we had three, which is better than zero, but it would have been nice to have had 50 or 20 or 10 or something, yeah. Anything more. But further, it would have been even better to have a B team. So what ended up happening, if you watch the video, we get kicked off of campus after we harangue her for about 5 minutes straight.
Yeah, you really had her stuck.
Yeah. Well, we were actually on our way off campus, but we couldn't go back as a result of that was the issue.
Right, we were told to leave. Well, actually, we were told to leave. I don't think they said we couldn't come back. We were just told to leave the campus. We weren't no trespassed. They didn't give us any kind of actual order. But the general approach would be to leave for the day and not come back for the day, and that's what we did. But
we would have beaten any trespass order because it is public land,
right.
And we were engaged in First Amendment protected speech. So we were operating within their rules.
Absolutely true. And so what we could have used was a B team, though, to maybe another three people who weren't there the first time, who could have then gone there for the end of the ceremony and ambushed her as she was walking to her vehicle on the way out. So that would have been the ideal situation, but you know, that's why we need more activists up here in New Hampshire.
Yeah.
Come on up and join the fun.
I liked how you did it, and I liked how you guys are going up there in the legislature and stuff. It's cool seeing it on video. It's inspiring. So
thanks. Are you going to make a move to New Hampshire as part of the Free State Project?
I don't know, man. Actually, I think I met you at the Ron Paul rally in Tampa in 2012.
No, I was not there.
You were there.
Nope.
No, you were not. Well, the guy from up there, and he said, why don't you move up there? And I'm like, oh, because it's so cold. And he's like, you know what I did? I was like, what? And he's like, I bought a jacket.
Well, I'll tell you, I moved here from Florida, too.
Yeah.
And
same here. Three of us did.
When I told my father that I was moving to New Hampshire, he said, do you know where it is? And I said, well, of course I know where it is. And he said, but you hate the cold. And I said, Dad, without freedom, cold warmth is cold comfort.
No doubt. Carlos, thanks for the call tonight, man. I appreciate hearing from you.
Guys.
Yep, we will.
Peace.
You know, I think that I don't think that the weather claim is invalid when people look at New Hampshire. When I was you know, when we were voting on which state was going to be the home of the Free State Project, this is some years ago, I was pulling for Delaware because it was the farthest south of all of the states. But one thing you have to consider when you look at these states that are sort of between Florida and New Hampshire is that when these states get snow, it turns into sort of ice on the road, and like there's freezing rain, which is much more dangerous than snow. Snow's a pain in the butt. But, you know, having to move white stuff around is a pain. There's no doubt about it. But it's not as dangerous as freezing rain. And freezing rain's much more prevalent from essentially the Mason-Dixon line north to...
I didn't know that.
Much more common. And so, you know, it's not so bad when you look at it that way. And the cold doesn't bother me. Sometimes I go out and tend my fire, which is out just behind my house. I have an outdoor wood boiler because I want to, you know, heat from the wood on my land. I go out and tend it with no jacket on at all.
Well, the cold bothers me, I'll tell you that. I've got like no skin on my bones. I'm a very, very skinny guy, and it's easy for me to get cold. I'll sometimes get cold in my own house. If it's 70 degrees, my feet will be cold if they're touching the floor. So to me, it was definitely something that I had to get over, was the idea of it's going to be cold quite a bit up there. But yeah, there are jackets. There are not only jackets, but they have like heat pouches or like I've got this battery thing that I bought on Amazon, which was $40 or something like that. And this was 2 or 3 years ago now. This is it's like a rechargeable battery that instead of putting out power, it puts out warmth. And it actually does have a power port on it, so you can use it to charge your phone if you wanted to. But I use that to warm my hands up during, you know, if I'm out doing activism in the cold during the wintertime. So there are tools, you know, the market has come up with ways to deal with cold. But to me, being around thousands of people who love liberty is so worth it. 855-450-FREE, you can join us here. Go to freestateproject.org and learn more about it. We'll come back with more Free Talk Live.
It's time to build your own emergency food stockpile with the industry leader, My Patriot Supply. Once you try them, you'll know why so many Americans like you have made them part of their emergency preparedness plan. Experience the My Patriot Supply difference today with this unbelievable offer. Right now, a 4-week food supply is only $99, and that includes free shipping. That's 50% off the online price. Call 800-274-3070 to claim yours. Limit 2 per caller while supplies last. This offer isn't available online, so you want to make sure and grab this opportunity to get prepared today. 800-274-3070 to get your 4-week food supply for the incredible price of only $99, and it'll be shipped to you completely free. Call 800-274-3070 right now. That's 800-274-3070 to claim yours while supplies last. Don't wait. Call today.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit LibertyOnTheRocks.org today to get started.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com. Are you looking for an excuse to come check out New Hampshire this fall? You're invited to Keenvention. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, do some Robin Hooding, and learn about making the move. Keenvention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year's keynote speeches and panels will be announced via the Keenvention blog and Facebook, so stay tuned there for the latest. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 30th through November 1st. Tickets are available now at a special early bird price of just $50 via credit card or Bitcoin. That $50 price only lasts through the end of June, so don't delay. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more and look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
Listen to LRN.FM on any phone, anytime, 213-493-0309. That's 213-493-0309.
This is Free Talk Live. You can bring up anything you want here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've got a website. You can go there, get interactive. You can actually submit content right to the front page of the site, vote on what is there. So you see something you like, you can vote it up. If you don't like something, you can vote it down. It's a Reddit-based system, so that means it's free for you to use. In fact, the entire website's free. You can download archives. You can go grab our YouTube videos. It's all there, and there's a lot there. I can't even tell you about half of it here. So go and check it out. Explore on and at your leisure. Over at freetalklive.com. As we go back to your phone calls and thoughts, we've got Doug on the line in Manchester. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Doug.
Hi, guys. I just had a couple quick questions. Ian, have you ever volunteered for Keene State High School?
Keene State High School. There is no Keene State High School.
Keene High School.
Keene High School. Have I volunteered? Yes.
Like after prom parties or...
So there is a thing they do called Project Graduation here in Keene, and basically I don't think it has to do with prom, but it does have to do with graduation. So the seniors who are leaving the school have this Project Graduation thing where like they have a bunch of games and things like that that they
gymnasium.
Set up in the gymnasium and such. And
I thought that was you.
Oh, there you go. So, yes, I have done that. I've done that multiple years. I wasn't able to do it last year because they actually had it, I think it was like the same week of Porkfest, or there was something else going on. Some sort of thing conflicted with it, so it was my first year of not being able to do it. But I've actually done it like at least 3 years now at this point. Why do you ask?
Oh, I was there. I was working the event, and I saw you a few times on the camera, and I said, geez, it looks like him, and I almost introduced myself, but...
Next time, feel free.
Yeah. And also, I know you said on the air that you don't own guns, and Mark, he can't own guns, but did you guys ever bring up to the governor about she wants to veto the constitutional carry in New Hampshire that got passed?
I'm a big supporter of the right to defend oneself, and while I don't currently own a gun, I do actually have possession of one. But nonetheless, that is an important issue, and it really did well in the state house. That passed with flying colors in the New Hampshire state house. I don't know if the Senate has voted on that yet here in New Hampshire. So for our listeners that don't know what we're talking about, New Hampshire is one of the best states to live in as far as gun freedoms are concerned. But there are a couple of states that are better, including Vermont and Alaska, where you don't need to ask permission from the government to concealed carry. That's something that you do have to do here in New Hampshire, and that is what this legislation would have changed. In this case, no, and at least in the instance with me and Rich, we targeted her over the cannabis issue, which is one on which she's particularly weak, and that was just the issue we happened to choose But I do.
It would have been great if another person would have gone out on that a similar issue, but right. It's hard to get folks to come out.
Yeah, being a felon now, it's very difficult for me to argue too much about gun rights. I don't focus there, just because people will say, "Well, you're a criminal, you shouldn't be carrying anyway." But you know, I open carried every day from the time I moved to New Hampshire up until after I was arrested.
Yeah. I would love to see like a group of felons put together some sort of an activist group, like, you know, Felons for Firearm Rights or something like that, giving these politicians a hard time. Like, look, you know, we're productive members of society. We're not a danger to anybody. And we should be able to protect ourselves and our family. I think that would be an interesting project.
Every argument there is for people being able to carry guns, like, you know, when seconds count, the cops are only minutes away. That's true for felons, too. I've got a family, and the suggestion...
And a felony.
Yeah, and a felon, and I'm a felon. And the suggestion that I can't have a gun to protect my family...
Nor can your wife.
Well... The law is really shifty on that, and it depends on the state and the region you're in and which judge you get and all kinds of stuff.
Isn't it active possession, though? Like, if you could access that firearm before she could, then that would...
Right. I mean, but there's not a police officer around every second to define what active possession is.
But there would be police if somebody tried to break into your house and they got shot. Right?
Sure. Like, but, I mean, something as simple as a trigger lock, you know, basically solves the active possession issue. So
if you were to put a trigger lock in the gun before the police showed up, then they wouldn't be able to prove that you had access to it?
Well, that you could, if you owned a trigger lock, the police couldn't prove that it wasn't on the gun beforehand, right, or whatever. Like, for instance, there's...
Well, they could if you got it out of the lock and your wife wasn't home. But then again, you know, it's generally better to be tried by 12 than carried by 6. Thank you.
Doug, was there anything else you wanted to share on that conversation?
Yes. So the Senate did pass that bill.
Oh, they did?
And she said she was going to veto it, but she's going to be running for re-election or for senator. So anybody in New Hampshire listening, give her a call, tell her not to veto it, harass her, whatever.
Thanks, Doug, for your call tonight, man. I appreciate it. Next time you see me, come up, say hi. I appreciate that, too. Our toll-free number here, 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. We were talking about activist tactics, and Ethan Glover over at ethanglover.biz is earlier was critiquing Rich Paul and I. I think he's going to come back around to that. But what he's talking about is looking at data as far as, you know, the results of the activism that you're doing. And he's right now focusing on the idea of getting into online arguments with people, which I don't really consider to be activism. Rich, I think you made a good argument for it as possible, like promotion or marketing for a brand or something like that. But generally, if you're spending your time having an argument with people online, it's my opinion, you could be doing something more productive.
You're using the term argument, and you tend to fixate on that.
Yeah.
Would you say that having discussions with people online that are of a pro-liberty nature is activism?
Not if it's arguing with people, okay. I would say no. Well, and I would say that, you know,
argumentation has several different...
Educating people.
Right. You didn't answer my question, which is a nasty political sort of thing to do. And secondly, argue, mm-hmm, to argue a point doesn't necessarily mean to raise one's voice or call names or anything like that. It simply means to put forth an idea. So argue can have different definitions.
Tend to think it's a waste of time. Whether you want to call it arguing or discussing, I tend to think that you could be doing something more productive typically.
Yeah, well, I mean, especially if you have a nationally syndicated radio program, I would absolutely agree with you. And frankly, anybody who has a particular bend, they ought to call Free Talk Live and discuss it that way, because you're going to have a much more honest conversation rather than online, where people just, you know, they don't respond to points. They talk past one another, disingenuous as they could possibly be.
So he says when they report back to their friends, talking about people arguing online, laughing about how they trolled the enemy and pointing out responses that they know their friends will disagree with, they are participating in what I call clickbaiting, as in C-L-I-Q-U-E, a clique, clickbaiting. After failing to make a positive difference, these people run back to their own isolated communities and joke about how stupid everyone else is. It's like a 12-year-old boy getting rejected by a girl and then going back to his friends to call her a slut. The end result is a group of boys and girls hating one another because of some artificially created drama. Instead of getting laid, the boy expends his remaining energy and time on blaming his failures on the girls. Cliquebaiting is when one refuses to improve themselves and isolates themselves into groups that accept his or her failures in light of what they see as the failures of the failures or ignorance of other groups. This practice does nothing but create tension between two groups.
I tend to agree with that.
Here's the most important part. If only one group participates in cliquebaiting and the other refrains from retaliating, it is the other that wins public opinion. When Ian Freeman yells at Maggie Hassan and Hassan never publicly responds, it's only the obnoxious behavior of Ian that the public sees. The context doesn't matter when there is no reply. Now, I disagree with that because, you know, it's... Everybody's opinion is different. There is no such thing as public opinion. Each individual who observes the activism that we perform, in this case, the cornering of the governor, each individual is going to bring different observations and beliefs to that experience. So it's going to speak to some people in a very positive way. They want to see the governor get what's for. And then to other people who have respect for the office and the government and all that, they're going to be insulted. Or to people who are easily, you know, offended, they're going to be offended by it. So to say that there is such a thing as winning public opinion, I don't know what that means. 855-450-FREE. We'll continue here in moments, and you can share your thoughts with us on tactics or whatever's on your mind on Free Talk Live.
You've helped make Lumber Liquidators North America's largest specialty retailer of hardwood flooring. To say thanks, we've made unbelievable price cuts on top quality floors at our customer appreciation sale. It's your chance to get pre-finished hardwood for just 99 cents and strand bamboo, our most durable bamboo, from an incredible $149. Plus deals on 400 beautiful floors, including quality laminate from 49 cents and 24-month special financing. You trust our value, we value your trust. So get to the customer appreciation sale today. Visit lumberliquidators.com to find a store near you.
Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
Gold isn't for you?
Ted Anderson, president of Midas Resources, one of the world's premier gold and precious metal investing firms.
I get it.
You wouldn't buy gold if you believed that the government is doing a great job, that the Fed will stop handing out trillions of dollars like bailout candy, that Social Security would be there for you. That's not what's happening. You might even pass on gold if the stimulus package wouldn't fuel inflation, or that the dollar wouldn't lose value, or that your retirement would be secure. If all looks rosy to you, then now is not the time to buy gold. For the realist, there have never been more sobering reasons to diversify with gold. Since 2001, the U.S. dollar index has tanked 30% while gold has risen 300%. Right now, savvy investors are adding gold to their portfolios. You should too. Find out what they know. Call us and I'll send you 10 reasons why gold will do very well, free. 800-686-2237. 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
Cato University is the Cato Institute's premier educational event of the year. It's being held this year from July the 26th to the 31st at the Cato Institute's state-of-the-art headquarters in Washington, D.C. This annual program brings together outstanding faculty and participants from across the country and often from around the globe, with everyone sharing a commitment to liberty and learning. Cato University is a genuine community, and you can freely share viewpoints, concerns, ideas, questions, and more in an atmosphere of friendship and personal respect. It's a one-of-a-kind program for people who don't stop thinking after they got out of school. It's for people who don't want politicians or bureaucrats or officials to do their thinking for them. It's for people who value liberty. You'll learn, you'll be inspired, you'll make new friends, you'll meet great people from around the world. All of the details are spelled out at the Cato website, cato.org, and they hope to see you there this summer, July the 26th through the 31st in Washington, D.C. Again, details are at cato.org.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
New Hampshire is under quarantine as walking corpses devour the flesh of the living. Max is 11 years old and surviving alone. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the dead swarm his home. Now he must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to improvise his escape. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook, read reviews on Amazon, or read Chapter 1 at SurvivorMax.com.
You can interact with other LRN listeners in our message board at forum.lrn.fm. That's forum.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. Join us here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. Is it bad to corner the governor and pepper him or her with questions that they don't want to hear, that some people might be upset by? Well, that's one of the things that might be being suggested here by a critic of some of the activism that you and I recently engaged in, Rich Paul. We're going to continue with that critique here in a moment. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. You can join us online at freetalklive.com. And if you like this show and you want to help support what we're doing, you can go and shop with us at shop.freetalklive.com. What you do is you enter Amazon through the links you'll find there. There's Amazon US, UK, and Canada. Just go into the right Amazon for you, and Free Talk Live will get a cut of the purchase price. Whatever it is that you're looking to buy, Free Talk Live will get a cut of it when you go through shop.freetalklive.com. So Ethan Glover over at ethanglover.biz, a new mover, actually, a relatively new mover for the Free State Project. So, you know, this guy's got credit, at least some level of cred, right? He moved. Mm-hmm. He picked up and he moved for the Free State Project. This isn't your average YouTube commenter who's critiquing us here. So I'm certainly taking it more seriously than I would, you know, the average YouTube comment. Going on here, though,
well,
in the
previously what he had said was this, he was sort of analogizing your activism to a junior high boy going and asking a girl at a dance, and, you know, her turning him down, and then him going back to his group and, you know, calling her a slut or whatever.
I wouldn't say that's accurate.
Okay, what's accurate?
Well, I would say that is inaccurate specifically because we're putting our activism out there for everyone to see.
Right.
I never expected to convince Maggie Hassan, so if that is the...
And I don't want to date her either.
Right. Exactly. Well, what he says is that he doesn't like this because it just separates the two groups. Well, the groups we're talking about here are essentially activists and, you know, libertarian activists and statists who support the governor. There's a lot of people in between who can come to whatever conclusion they come to, and I suspect that some of them will come to the conclusion that, as he says, you guys acted like a couple of douchebags.
Yep, that's true.
Some people will come to that conclusion. Mm-hmm. Now, I don't know the percentage, and I think that this is different because we're talking about a politician here, and politicians look for popular support. Generally, their support tends to be less than 50%, the people that say, "Oh, they're doing a good job," often can be peeled off when you talk about a specific issue. Oh yeah, well, do you know what she has? What she says about marijuana legalization or about constitutional carry, or about
most people wouldn't know
Common Core. Mm-hmm. Well, you guys addressed your group addressed a couple of issues there, marijuana and Common Core, and that peels off. I don't think there's very many Democrats that are like, we hate Common Core. Maybe there are. I don't know the answer to that. But usually the Democrats tend to kind of shore up around the teachers union. The teachers union tends to be around Common Core. But nonetheless, that gets the Republican types like, yeah, Common Core, bad. Fine. From what I can tell, it's bad. But it also, many of the marijuana activists tend to be sort of leaning Democrat. And this just kind of peels them off and says, hey, look, turns them against their governor.
That's the idea, is to bring people's attention to these issues and further to bring people's attention to the activism going on here in New Hampshire. This is also a beacon to liberty people all around the world saying, hey, come here and you can join in and do some real activism for once.
And that is a kind of clickbaiting that I'm definitely looking to do. I mean, I'm looking to get that message out that we're here, and I'm looking to get that message out to people specifically who believe the same things that we believe.
Absolutely.
And are willing to work to achieve that. So, you know, and people like that, I think, are going to look at what at the kind of thing that we do and say, I want to be out there doing that.
We've had people say that. We've had people say that we're living their dream.
Yeah.
That's literally what somebody said, because they're in a state where you can't access the governor at all ever, because she's always got a, or he or she always has a huge security contingent. This lady's got one security guard. We're in New Hampshire. Everything's small here. You know, the government is very small. The governor's security detail is one man.
Yep.
That's it. So it's not hard to get close to this lady when she's in a public place. And so other people are looking at this like, you know, somebody in California. It's like, I wouldn't be able to even say word one to the governor of California. You guys are doing amazing work. And this is some of the commentary that we've received.
Many of the people that support Free Talk Live and support the Shire Free Church and, you know, other activist groups, you know, they're, you know, business owners that say to themselves, I have been screwed so badly by the government. Like, they're literally angry and they want to, you know, go after the governments in any way they can. Now, we try not to sound particularly angry. You guys certainly, you know, you were like, shame on you, Maggie. And
yeah,
there was
shame
some,
on her.
There was some level of sort of recrimination in your voice. There's no doubt about it.
Yep.
But
I wasn't being nice to her.
Right. It's not like you were getting in her face. You weren't like waving something at her threateningly or anything like that. None of that was going on. You guys are pros when it comes to activism. You know what you can do and what you can't do, what sort of works and what doesn't work. And one of the reasons you know is because you take critique. You're reading this guy's blog, and frankly, I don't know, his blog is liable to, I don't even have the terminology, have 10 times, 100 times the hits it's had in the past.
I don't know.
Free Talk Live effect.
Get a little bump. I don't know if it's going to be a whole lot. But.
Well, I mean, you know, a lot of people aren't going to, but he, you know, when was the last time his blog was promoted on a nationally syndicated radio program?
Let's talk to Dennis in Concord, another guy I got a lot of respect for, who's done a lot of activism up
here. And disagrees with you often.
Sometimes, yeah. I saw him the other night, actually, earlier this month. We went to a new movers party, and he was there. At least I presume this is the same Dennis. Dennis, you're on Free Talk Live.
Yeah, it's me. I love you. You know, though you pissed me off so GD much, it just is impossible. To... Anyways, but I do
Your feelings are your own responsibility, Dennis, not mine.
So, you know, you guys were talking about meeting the governor. The first time I met the governor in New Hampshire, I had no idea he was going to be there. I just went to the fair in the town I live in. There's a pretty big fair. It's like the Hopkinton Fair.
Mm-hmm.
It's a couple years ago. And the governor of the state was basically standing sort of near one of the entrance gates where people, you know, you have your hand stamped, you come in. And he's kind of standing there alone, basically looking awkward, looking like
yep.
the guy at the dance who doesn't know how to ask the girls to come over and
she totally looked that way, too. When we were at this event at the college, she was just standing kind of alone, looking around, didn't really. Well, she wasn't schmoozing as much as I expected her to be. I'm sorry to interrupt, but go ahead.
Oh, that's fine. I mean, and in this case, it was Governor Lynch who came before Hassan.
Mm-hmm.
And he's just, just kind of hanging around, hoping someone will come up and talk to him. I came up, I shook his hand, and at the time, the real ID thing was a really big thing with New Hampshire being the most forceful, you know, no, we're not going to participate. And I just shook his hand and said, you know, Governor, if you tell the federal government that we're not going to go along with real ID, you're okay in my book. Just like that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if there's one thing that really mattered to me at that time, that was
yep.
it. I had a billion things I disagree with a guy on, but I feel like that was a not a small thing, like, you know, just connecting in the head of, it's a lot like dealing with executives at a company. They don't have a lot of attention. They can just sort of get a general gist, like a general flash of, okay, people feel this way. That's all you can communicate, and that's fine. And I think that plays right into what you guys were doing with present Governor Maggie. You know, some things that whoever's critiquing you ought to keep in mind. Effectively, no one's going to see that video, at least nobody in New Hampshire. Nobody in New Hampshire has seen that video. Some libertarians, yes, but effectively, nobody in New Hampshire has seen that video, or is likely to.
Well, I don't know. I mean, I've had people walk up to me on the street and say thank you for it who aren't necessarily libertarians. But
very few, I think, is what he's trying to say.
Oh, yeah, a very small percentage of New Hampshireites are actually going
to
see
that
video.
Yeah, I think it's only got 5,000 views.
That would even compared to the number of people that would even read, say, a letter to the editor in the newspaper, right? Vanishingly small compared to that. And there weren't even really bystanders. Yes, there were people around, but it's not like this was in front of a big candidate event where a lot of people are there. This, you know, no one saw this happen effectively.
Right.
The most important person to see this happen was the governor herself. And the important thing to communicate that I think you did was just, well, see, here's the thing. What was first, just, you know, there is public displeasure at this, and people are really pissed off. People are upset. It's not just like, oh, I disagree with you on this. It's, no, this is like you've torn down like someone's last straw.
There need to be consequences for people who take the wrong position on the on marijuana decriminalization. She needs to feel that.
Mm-hmm. There's a great pro-liberty rep who was actually in New Hampshire long before the Free State Project even got selected, who I think he was retelling this from wisdom from far earlier on, but he really drove it home to me. When they feel the heat, they see the light. That is how you got to think about your politicians.
I think more people need to give feedback like this to politicians. If you want, got more comments, stand by, Dennis. We can bring it back here. Coming up in hour number three, 855-450-FREE.
I think it's important that you guys stuck to one issue, too. Yeah. Per each individually, one issue. That way you said, this is important to me. And Dennis had really sort of said that with Governor Lynch, too.
Specifically wanted to call her out as a hypocrite as well, considering she smoked pot. It's Free Talk Live.
New Hampshire is under quarantine as walking corpses devour the flesh of the living. Max is 11 years old and surviving alone. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the dead swarm his home. Now he must apply his porcupine Freedom Scouts training to improvise his escape. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook, read reviews on Amazon, or read Chapter 1 at SurvivorMax.com.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust, who will never betray you, or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom, and with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
I love my magic mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found my magic mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My magic mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to mymagicmud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin, mymagicmud.com.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Tuesday, May 19th, 2015. Silver is trading at $17.53 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,221 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $234. Antiwar.com reports the authorization for use of military force for the war against the Islamic State, which has been raging for 9 months now, has still not been brought to a vote, and the recent indications are it probably never will be. Representative Adam Schiff of California said the snag is there is no real political will or interest in doing this, saying no vote on the war would be a terrible precedent. Yet that seems to be where things are headed, as the White House unveiled its proposed AUMF bill and quickly alienated most of the public by saying it was deliberately vague to allow them to expand the war at will. In the lead up to last November's election, there was little interest in a politically volatile vote, and now that the war has been going on so long, most of the Republican leadership, which supports the war at any rate, seems to see no need to put anything on paper.
For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. UPI reports President Obama announced federal standards to improve trust between police and communities and a ban on some types of military equipment for local police agencies. Obama spoke on the measures Monday in Camden, New Jersey, a city that has struggled with one of the country's highest violent crime rates. A blueprint for improved community policing was announced that will help cities and towns develop policing strategies that work best for building trust between law enforcement and the communities they serve while enhancing public safety. Obama pointed to work Camden has done to grow trust between the city's residents and its police force and a subsequent drop in violent crime, murder, and open-air drug markets. The White House will attempt to create improved methods of using data and technologies in ways to build community trust and reduce unnecessary uses of force. The Department of Justice recently announced a new program that will help law enforcement agencies implement the use of body-worn cameras on officers, which will be further supported by the White House. Tools cities can utilize will be presented as part of the Task Force on 21st Century Policing program that can be used to build and maintain the all-important trust between the law enforcement officers and the communities they have sworn to serve and protect. Meanwhile, the White House announced a list of items that are banned from being acquired by local police under select federal programs. The list includes tracked armored vehicles, weaponized aircrafts and vehicles, bayonets, grenade launchers, and large caliber firearms. During his speech in Camden, Obama said, "We've seen how militarized gear sometimes gives people a feeling like they're an occupying force as opposed to part of a community they're there to protect. Some equipment made for the battlefield is not appropriate for local police departments." Under more rigorous control, law enforcement agencies will still be able to acquire armored vehicles, tactical vehicles, riot gear, and specialized firearms and ammunition. In Survivor Max by Davi Barker, 11-year-old Max must survive the zombie apocalypse alone in New Hampshire. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the lame brains swarm his home searching for living flesh. Max must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to plan his escape, but first, he must prove that he's too smart to die. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook and Amazon, or read Chapter 1 free at SurvivorMax.com. Reuters reports four passengers on the Amtrak commuter train that derailed in Philadelphia last week filed a federal lawsuit on Monday against the rail service. The lawsuit filed in Philadelphia cited serious and disabling injuries from the May 12th derailment that killed eight people and injured more than 200 others. Nearly a week after the derailment, it remains a mystery what caused the train to accelerate from 70 miles per hour to 106 miles per hour in a minute before the crash. Authorities have not yet ruled out equipment malfunction, human error, or other possible reasons for the train gaining speed so rapidly. This lawsuit appears to be the first filed by a non-employee of Amtrak. Last week, an Amtrak employee who was riding the train as a passenger filed the first lawsuit, citing a brain injury he suffered in the crash. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Do you sometimes feel that healthy eating can be a lot of work with very little reward? Well, no need to worry any longer. Here are the Onion's tips for healthy eating. First, identify your weaknesses and then condition yourself to avoid problem foods by associating them with deceased relatives, unrequited loves, and traumatic events. Remember, alcohol is a source of empty calories, so be sure to keep your drinking under control. Unless you're really f***ing stressed out. Like if something shitty happens at work, or if your cat gets hit by a car. If you find yourself suddenly craving a fatty food, let yourself enjoy the best of both worlds. Tape a slice of ham to your tongue and slowly absorb the taste throughout the day without swallowing. Stay motivated by paying yourself $1 every day until you meet your weight loss goals. At the end of 10 years' time, spend that cash on a cosmetic operation of your choice. There, now you're ready to begin your new healthy lifestyle.
This is the Onion News Network.
This This is Free Talk Live. We're launching into the third hour of the program. You can dial and join us here at 855-450-FREE. We're talking about tactics, activism, and offense, offending people. People, you know, when they see activism, a lot of them, they don't like it because they'd rather just be going about their lives and not be molested by any unwanted messages and ideas that they've never considered before. And so it's uncomfortable to hear things that are, like, you know, challenging to their belief systems. And
in
so,
some cases, it's not even they may agree with them, and right. They still just like, I don't like activism.
Right. So we got Rich Paul and Mark and Ian in the studio here. We've also got Dennis on the line in Concord. I held him over from the last hour because I felt like you weren't quite done with what you wanted to share, which was about confronting the governor of a state, which is what Rich Paul and I had the opportunity to do just a couple of weeks ago, about a week and a half ago, during the just before, actually, the Keene State College graduation. We cornered Maggie Hassan, who is the New Hampshire governor, and peppered her with tough questions about marijuana decriminalization and her hypocrisy on it, considering that she refuses to sign marijuana decrim thus far and yet has admitted to having used marijuana in the past. I made sure to point that out on the video for anyone who does watch this. And as you rightly pointed out, Dennis, very few people in New Hampshire are going to see this particular video, maybe a few hundred or so, maybe 1,000. Most of the views are going to come from outside of New Hampshire on this. But nonetheless, I appreciate where you're coming from thus far, but go ahead with other thoughts you want to share. Do we have Dennis? Dennis in Concord? At least I thought he was still there. Dennis going once. Dennis going twice. Maybe he is on a cell phone, and in which case we're going to put him back on hold and give him another shot here in just a moment. So let's continue. Meanwhile, we've got an article here from EthanGlover.biz. He's a relatively new mover to the Keene area of New Hampshire as part of the Free State Project, and he has a few things that he's been saying here that are somewhat critical of our approach. He says, if, say, there were a debate between Freeman, that's me, and Hassan, that's the governor, and both parties—
Which, of course, there was an opportunity for that, and Hassan turned it down.
She, correct, refused to debate me when I ran against her for governor.
You were running, you know, as a Democrat in the primary against the governor and giving people an option, and she did not respond to a debate, and so you got, what, 10 minutes up on the stage to make your points or whatever?
That's correct. And I was able to give the opening speech to the Republican debate, which was really cool. I had a lot of fun doing that. So I have to thank Maggie Hassan for refusing the debate to give me an uninterrupted session in front of the Republican debate, which otherwise wouldn't have happened had she not turned it down. Anyway, he says, and both parties kept their cool in the debate. Points on both sides would be considered by most listeners. Granted, the likelihood of this happening, even ignoring Ian's recent actions toward Hassan, are slim. A sit-down interview is possible, but the value gained from it is most likely negligible without perfectly crafted questions and perfect calm on the side of the interviewee. I'm sorry, Ethan, but it's really not possible. The level of possibility to have a sit-down interview with Maggie Hassan as a political opponent or someone who is critical of her is, I'd say, about 0.01%.
Right. Like, Maggie Hassan isn't going to sit down and let a principled voluntarist, debate occur right. with a voluntarist referee against a voluntarist debate. I mean, this is ludicrous. This is simply not going to happen. We're not there where we're having debates between statists and statist positions and voluntarists.
She has no reason to debate me.
If
Ethan is listening, I invite you to prove us wrong by getting a call back from Maggie Hassan's press secretary.
Just get the call back.
Maybe you can debate her.
Right. Just try getting a call back, let alone an actual debate scheduled with
this
lady.
Wasn't he saying that the debate was of mitigable value? Wasn't that what his point was? Or was I mishearing?
No, he said that if we had a debate and both parties kept our cool, then the listeners would consider both sides. But because she didn't speak in response to the points I was making, he said that I was therefore losing.
Well, is the claim that the only videos of value are videos where we have a structured debate?
Because that
doesn't make much sense. There's all different kinds of people in the world, and they react to all different kinds of things.
Exactly.
I would say that Ethan's probably extraordinarily rational individual and therefore wants to hear
very rational forms of debate and discourse. And I would challenge Ethan to think about the world in which he lives and ask himself, are you actually dealing with a lot of rational people? I looked at the Myers-Briggs tests here. Ian,
he's gonna
I think
get
you,
into that here in a moment.
You actually, you're an INTJ, is that
I
right?
I don't remember. That sounds plausible.
That's what you had said in the past. I don't know, Rich.
I don't know what I would test as today,
I've never taken the test.
Okay, I've taken it several times.
I took it when I was a kid.
And I suspect you are, maybe you've changed, but people do change throughout their lives. What I've taken the test three times, got three different results. And the reason is, I believe, because I answered it well the last time. I'm an ESTP, which is essentially, somebody who tends to be a bit of a chameleon for their environment. So, I could tell a fib real well if it came down to it. And it's difficult to put on to quantify these these personality traits, but once you do, there's only like 2.5% of the population that's the same personality type as I am. You have to be able to deal with, and it's similar for you too, Ian, and probably similar for Ethan. You're dealing with people who have completely different personality types and look at the world differently.
Right.
Nope. I mean, if you go on YouTube and you look at what gets people's attention, you're going to see lots of videos of cats and dancing and cartoon characters. If you go ahead and look at the structured debate videos, you're not going to find very many views on those.
It's true. So he goes on to say, the point is, Hassan is not a good target. Changing her mind on an issue or making her feel bad for winning a majority election to become the governor of New Hampshire is a task too difficult to bother with. It's like digging for diamonds in a gold mine. But it's statements like this that reveal that people, coming from Ethan's perspective, really don't understand the goal of what Rich Paul and I were doing. It was not our goal to change her mind on an issue. I did not go into that expecting that anything that came out of my mouth would be seriously considered by this woman. So I wasn't expecting her to not even, let alone change her mind, but to even consider the words coming out of my mouth. Further, I can't control how she feels, so I'm not there to try to make her feel bad. Would I like her to feel bad about her hypocrisy on marijuana decriminalization? Yeah, I'd like that to happen. But as far as I'm concerned, my words are going in one ear and out the other and not even registering with this lady.
I think that this absolutely registers with this lady. This is not something she had to stand there for 5 minutes while you guys berated her.
But how does she feel? I don't know.
Human.
Yeah.
And she's going to have a reaction to this. Now, granted, the reaction is somewhat negative, but even with negative reinforcement, oftentimes people, now I'm not saying she's normal folks, I don't know. I think it takes a bit of a sociopath to make it to these higher levels of government, but I would think about this. This would be something that would
if
be
you
on
were
my
her,
mind.
You're saying?
Okay. Right. If this was me, I would hear this. Whether or not I changed the way of doing things depends on, a variety of factors, but I'd remember it.
If there was an emotional reaction that I wanted to evoke, I would say it was probably embarrassment. And basically, because I wanted her to be thinking about the impact of knowing about these things would do to her electorate. And that was a terrible sentence that I won't try to reconstruct. But
you wanted her to know people were upset.
I wanted her to know that people were upset, and I wanted her to be thinking, will people think less of me after they see this video? And hopefully the people who didn't know that she smoked weed herself,
yes,
but yet happily imprisons people for doing the same.
You didn't and even know
fights,
it.
I didn't even know
you
it.
You found out in
and,
the video.
Yeah, and fights to maintain their authority,
yeah,
to ruin people's lives for things they did themselves. I certainly think people should think less of her after knowing that.
And
if
this
they
is
can
the only way to do
less
it.
Of her.
I mean, look, this is the only way to accomplish those
things.
Well,
I don't know that that's necessarily true. I would like to hear other better ways
please
to accomplish
these
things.
Yeah, let me
things
know, because I can tell you. What I mean is, it's the only direct method, okay? This is very different of an approach than calling the governor's office, getting the secretary on the phone and saying, please let the governor know that I would like her to vote for decriminalization because of X, Y, and Z.
I did that.
I've done that too.
I precisely did that like 2 weeks
ago.
But
that's a totally different experience for her, right?
Some teenager answers the phone and says, yes, sir, you'll be sure to let her know.
Yeah, if they even let her know. Presuming they actually do give her a tally. Well, ma'am, we had 100 calls today saying you should decriminalize and 2 calls saying you needed to keep the status quo. That's totally different than being confronted on the street with people about how they really feel. More coming up on Free Talk Live, 855-450-4.
Retrievers, Labradors, Goldens are the main breeds that come through our door, but we'll train anything with 4 legs and a tail. My husband and I train hunting dogs and also have a boarding and grooming business. And our dogs, they're athletes, and we feed them very quality food. You can't get enzymes in a commercial dog food because they cook it at such a high heat, but adding Dynavite to their diet has every single dog in my kennel looking better than they have ever looked.
DINOVITE.com.
859-428-1000.
The omega-3 fatty acids.
Flaxseed, zinc, alfalfa.
The digestive enzymes that are cooked out of regular dog food.
Dynavite's the bomb.
Tell everybody we know about Dynavite.
Just feed your dog right. Use Dynavite. If it's working, don't quit.
When I get down to the bottom of my box to Dynavite, it's time to place my order.
DINOVITE.com.
859-428-1000.
859-428-1000. DINOVITE.com.
Gold. It's like nothing else on Earth. From the Romans through the Renaissance, from the Industrial Age to the Space Age, gold has weathered the test of time. For 6,000 years, gold has remained the ultimate store of wealth. According to the World Gold Council and the U.S. Mint, demand is at an all-time high. The stage is being set for the reemergence of gold as the common-sense alternative to a fiat paper currency that gets weaker every day. Midas Resources is proud to offer the hard-hitting report that arms you with the truth you need to protect you and your family from the Fed's plans for your hard-earned money. Don't gamble with your future. Call Midas Resources today and ask for your free copy of As Good as Gold. Call 1-800-686-2233 for the report the Fed hopes you'll never see. As Good as Gold can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. If you have ever thought about owning gold, you must read this report. Call Midas today at 800-686-2237.
This is the Onion Week in Review. According to sources, all 6.5 million residents of Indiana spontaneously formed thousands of perfectly uniform rows throughout the state Monday morning and established a collective consciousness. Saying, we are Indiana, the new hive mind talked and moved in unison, with citizens working together to build a massive geometric superstructure in downtown Indianapolis where they would gather to sleep, breed, and feed.
All the horns for Indiana. All the horns for Indiana.
The collective state went on to report that soon Ohio, Illinois, Michigan, Kentucky, and Canada would all become Indiana. Persons close to Phoenix area friends Jake Welter and Mike Ceflin confirmed Friday that the two men are absolutely incapable of greeting each other like normal human beings.
Beep, 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 beep.
Sources say the two full-grown men simply cannot walk into a room and shake each other's hands, relying instead on elaborate dances, forced pop culture references, and extended fake fighting. Neither Welter nor Ceflin was available for comment as they were busy pretending to rip each other's faces off.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com. Ross Ulbricht was convicted in early 2015 of running the infamous Silk Road Underground Market. The Silk Road was a gift to humanity and helped reduce the harms brought on by drug prohibition. For this good deed, Ross may be spending the rest of his life in prison. His family is planning to appeal his conviction, but they need your support. Please visit FreeRoss.org, where you can contribute via various methods, including Bitcoin. Ross needs your help now more than ever. Visit FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
That a law has been broken.
Hey, it's Free Talk Live. We'll talk to you about whatever's on your mind. You don't have to call and talk about tactics and activism, though that has been the focus of the discussion here thus far tonight. With you in studio, it's Ian,
Rich Paul,
and Mark.
And you can join us online. Just drop by freetalklive.com, where you can go back and dig into archives going back until 2006. And even beyond that, actually, we've got torrents of even older archives. So you can go and grab it all up for free over at freetalklive.com. And some of those old archives feature Brian Sovereign, who was for a long time a fixture on our Sunday show. He hosts his own show called Sovereign Tech, and he's also a video game designer now.
Yeah, he made a new game called Hypercronius. It's a role-playing game for Windows PCs. He is, like I said, a former co-host, and it's a story like no other game before. Full motion video, classic graphics, pick up and play controls. Hypercronius is a liberty-oriented experience. It's not to be missed. Go to zog.ninja. That's the website, zog.ninja, and find out more. See the trailer. Get your copy of Hypercronius. Use coupon code FTL. Get $1 off, and you can purchase it with Bitcoin if that's what you wish to do. Hypercronius at zog.ninja. Code FTL.
All right, I believe we've cleared up whatever the issue was with Dennis's connection before. Dennis in Concord, New Hampshire, are you back with us?
Welcome back, guys.
Excellent.
Welcome back, bro.
Yeah, what? I felt like you had more to say in the last hour, and I wanted to make sure you had that chance, so go ahead.
Yeah, I appreciate that. So you got to remember, the governor has announced she is not running for governor again. She's instead running for United States Senate.
Okay, I didn't know that was official. I had heard rumor that that was going to be the case. I didn't know that she'd officially announced that.
I have no idea whether the papers are filed, but she's in she's in.
Yep.
Now, she is a Democrat, and this issue, she has the real possibility of losing a good part of her base.
Yeah.
If you have a Republican candidate for governor, and possibly even for Senate, who is sounding more tolerant on this issue than she is, she's going to lose some of her base, and that's what she really needs to know. Now, what you guys need to know is that you were playing the blood sport of New Hampshire, which is politics, but you were playing very amateur. Affecting national-level races in New Hampshire is really fun, and anybody can do it, and literally affecting it, like significantly making a difference as to whether someone, you may not always be able to make it win or lose, but you can make them really work for it, and sometimes you can clobber them on it. And there's only a few things that you need to do to make that happen. Certainly one is bird dogging, as it's called, where you get a couple of people and a video camera, and you just ask the governor hard questions. What you guys were doing was not so much bird dogging as like taking a caged bird and blowing it away with a 12 gauge.
Okay, I'll accept that.
Typically the way to bird dog in a way that doesn't make you the outsider crazy tin hat guy, but like, oh, geez, I have to deal with this issue, is to show up at their events, preferably not to be a known wackaloon, as unfortunately you already are.
I bet she was nervous to some extent, because for a while, when I found her, she was just kind of, as I was describing earlier, just standing kind of alone almost. There were people around her, but they weren't really talking to her. And I was just standing there 25 or 30 feet away from her, looking straight at her, pointing a video camera at her. And she knows who I am because I've confronted her before, and I also ran against her for governor in the Democratic primary. And so she knows something's coming, right? There's Ian Freeman with a video camera standing 30 feet away, just
her
lurking.
Her former, the guy who was running against her in the primary. Right. She knows exactly who this guy is, and she knows it's coming.
But yeah, you're right, Dennis. As far as the bird dogging goes, going to an event where she's going to be speaking, maybe taking audience questions, peppering activists in throughout the crowd, so you've got people in different parts of the crowd sort of raising their hands to ask a question and then hitting her with something. That would be the classic form of bird dogging, right?
If you have that.
Exactly.
Yeah. If you have
and that.
That
would be a place. Oh, sorry. Go ahead, Rich.
I just wanted to point out quickly, if you have that forum, that's a great option, but you only have the forums with which you are presented.
That's true.
Well, see, that's the thing. She's running for U.S. Senate. She's going to have these all over the state for the next year and a half.
No doubt, no doubt. But this was our time to get her on this one, right? I mean, this was – she hasn't yet voted on marijuana decrim because
hadn't vetoed.
It hasn't gone through the Senate yet.
Okay.
And so
when you're bird dog. blogging, you're doing it ideally for the mainstream media that's there. Mm-hmm. You're also videoing it for self to make sure that it can get out, because that's the kind of thing that can go viral. And you want that question to be that nice question that brings people on board and does not divide. Like what you were doing was, you know, castigating, but that kind of question that's, you know, Ms. Hazen, you know, given that you admitted to youthful indiscretions using marijuana when you were in college, and yet you took a, you know, public policy stance continuing to incarcerate and make, you know, felons out of, or not felons, whatever, to, you know, to give prison time to people the same age as you did the same thing, how is it that you avoid the label of hypocrite?
I love it, and that would be a perfect question to ask in the right circumstances you're describing at one of these town meeting things that she's inevitably going to be holding as she's running for political office.
Dennis, lot of them,
what do you do
all over the state?
Okay, what do you do after? I think that's great. What do you do after she doesn't answer? She doesn't even give eye contact.
On stage, you're the only person asking that question, and everybody's paying
attention.
If
you've got the microphone, she's going to have to give you at least a pro forma response.
She'll
probably
have to dodge or something.
Probably she'll give you something canned about the drug war and the importance of it. But the thing is, if she dodges, then they see her dodge, and that still is. You don't have to get a direct, honest answer out of a politician to beat them, thank God, or they would be invincible.
hey, Dennis, good call.
You know, there's more than one thing to do. That's just one of them. But
absolutely.
I'll, you know,
and that's why we need more activists up here. We need more people here as part of the Free State Project so we can head them from all different sides. And thank you for the call tonight.
And let's talk more about directions of – I hope you're still hearing us, Dennis. Let's talk more about, you know – options that can be pursued, not necessarily instead of what we've done,
but in addition to them. I agree. Because I'll be outside of that bird dogging thing with my camera ready to ambush her on her way to her car. You know, that's the kind of thing that I'm good at.
One of the things that sort of is bringing up as far as her running for the U.S. Senate, I consider that sort of a victory. I have really no interest.
If she's bailing on the governorship, you mean?
Yeah, I have no interest in a politician that's asking to leave New Hampshire. Please, by all means, get the hell out of here. Go to Washington, D.C. That place is so corrupt and so broken that I would be happy to send our most corrupt and most mind-numbed, mouth-breathing politicians down there so the rest of the world has to deal with them. What concerns me is what goes on in the state of New Hampshire. Yes, there's all kinds of bad federal laws out there, but really, you know, state government has a lot more effect on my day-to-day life than the federal government does. I know a lot of people want to fix Washington, D.C., and I wish them all the best. I have given up. Completely given up on the very notion of that. I believe that a state government can tell Washington, D.C., no thank you. And that's what I'm interested in doing, you know, having New Hampshire do on a regular basis. Mm-hmm. So fine by me if Hassan, I don't care.
It's great news, actually, because it means that whoever the next governor is going to be someone new.
And indeed. Almost certainly better, because she's wrong even where the liberals are right.
Yep. She's a full-on statist.
Yeah, and I think what we need to have happen is multiple free staters need to run for the governorship. We need to have two free staters run as Democrats and two as Republicans, in my opinion.
And if Hassan won't debate them, they can debate each other.
Well, she's not going to run for governor.
Or
so
whoever
yeah.
it is.
Yeah, more coming up here in moments. This is Free Talk Live.
Friends, this is Alex Jones for MidasResources.com. For more than 15 years, I have exclusively used Midas Resources for all my precious metal needs. Whether it's bullion or collectibles you're looking for, Midas Resources is simply the best. I own my gold as a hedge against inflation. This Federal Reserve fiat currency could go the way of the Deutschmark and the Weimar Republic anytime. In these historically dangerous times, it makes sense to physically hold gold and silver. Midas already has some of the best deals in the industry. But if you give them a call and mention the radio special, they will give you a list of the day's super specials. Midas brokers are standing by to answer all your questions at 800-686-2237. They also have a lot of informative free literature explaining the opportunities and risk of holding precious metals. They are ready to answer your questions at 800-686-2237. Again, that's 800-686-2237.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the Liberty Media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com.
Did you know that Free Aid is a mutual aid, educational, and networking organization? At Free Aid, we support volunteers who provide first aid. We do outreach to the public about health and safety, and we bring together medically skilled freedom lovers. Free Aid is made possible by your generous support. Donors can receive great gifts like first aid kits, t-shirts, silver dime cards, and hoodies. The Free Aid Silver Dime Card Project is sponsored in part by Roberts & Roberts Brokerage, Freedom's Phoenix, and Don't Tread on Meme. Visit fr33aid.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies!
Jesus.
On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, the Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. Hey! That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air in your area. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how. Broadcast.lrn.fm.
Hey, it's Free Talk Live. We'll talk to you about whatever's on your mind here. 855-450-FREE. We're talking about activism, tactics, you know, what's effective, what's not. And we're here to take your calls about anything, though. 855-450-FREE. You can also join us online at freetalklive.com. We do, by the way, have a mobile site. So for those of you with a smartphone, if you want to access our live streams or the podcast easily from your mobile device, you just go to m.freetalklive.com. We are, by the way, in the midst of doing a website redesign. The new site has yet to launch. I'm hoping it'll be sometime in the summer when that actually happens. We're getting closer. And at that point, we will have what is called a responsive design. So hopefully that'll make the mobile experience even better. Right now, we do have a mobile site. It's m.freetalklive.com. Let's go to your calls and thoughts. James in Kalamazoo, Michigan, listening via TuneIn. Hello, James.
Gentlemen, hey. Before I get to my point, I called a couple weeks ago and told you about a tax increase proposal that the people in the state of Michigan overwhelmingly we're voting down, and our government here has essentially given us a big FU and a middle finger because today the governor Snyder now signed into effect a new internet sales tax.
Oh, no.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. So essentially they're punishing the people of the state of Michigan in a way that they can, and is going to be requiring sites like Amazon and Overstock to charge a sales tax. Yeah.
I wonder how many...
I wonder how many sites will become unavailable in Michigan, if any. That would be interesting, if because they don't have the infrastructure to do that, do they?
It would certainly require more programming for a lot of websites, because then they would have to, you know, hire a programmer to come in and make sure they have software that would calculate whether or not somebody's in Michigan, and if so, calculate the appropriate sales tax rate. Is Michigan one of those places where the counties can raise the sales tax more, like in Florida?
I believe not. And I am a native Michigander, and I believe it was consistent throughout the state.
Do you know,
I
James?
Lived there.
Yeah, pretty much all the laws are preemptive, so which means that local municipalities cannot make them stricter. I know for sure all the gun laws can't be... That's preemptive. So,
because I know that in Florida, where I'm from, the county I lived in had a 1% higher sales tax mark than the county that you were born in originally, or that you were lived in for a lot of time. So Manatee County was 6%, Sarasota County was 7%. It might have gone up since then.
I thought it was
then.
7 and 8, but okay.
Yeah, it may have gone up since that the time that I was there.
And actually, I'm not sure now because I know that local municipalities can charge income tax. Hmm. As several do, like Detroit does, Battle Creek does, and a couple others. Yeah, so, yeah.
As if you needed another reason not to live in Detroit.
Right.
Well, it's the people that work there
and
don't necessarily live there.
So, yet another reason to join the Free State Project, if you love liberty, is the fact that there is no sales tax. On most things. There's the meals tax in New Hampshire, but
that's technically an excise and not a sales tax.
Is that right?
Because it's so specific, I believe.
James, anything else you want to share?
Yeah, I just kind of wanted to put out there. First off, I think that until you find out the forms of activism that actually are effective and work, you need to try them all. And then I also wanted to throw out there, I know I probably don't have much time, but and it's something that came to me when I started becoming sort of an activist and started looking for ways to get active in my area is, you know, being a freedom lover. If I want to enjoy the fruits of other activists, I feel like it's almost an obligation if you're a liberty lover to actually become an activist. I just feel like it's a moral thing because, you know, everybody wants the fruits of the labor of what, you know, for example, the Free State Project is doing. But a lot of people just would rather sit on their hands and not do anything.
See, I agree with you that if you're out there and you believe in these ideas that you should be doing something,
yep.
But not everybody has to be on the front line.
That's true.
I mean, the people who are out here doing this are mostly living very close to the bone. You know, I know I've been, all of my meals today have been ramen noodles. and, you know, it's a good thing to divide labor. So if you don't have time or energy or courage to do activism yourself, I would say send some money to somebody who does and make it possible for them to keep doing it.
Oh, definitely. But I feel like, you know, you almost have an obligation to be active in some way, even if it's supporting another group.
And sure. that is activism.
I agree. The behind-the-scenes activism is as important. If there's no support structure behind the scenes for the activists who are on the front lines, then that's tough. But I do understand where James is coming from in that, you know, there are a lot of people who feel like they don't want to do anything, right? They don't want to put themselves out there and possibly receive the ire of people who otherwise might respect them, right? Because to put yourself out there as an activist, you know, even if it is behind the scenes to a lesser extent, but mostly to the front line, means that there are going to be people who dislike you. And a lot of people want to be liked by people. So that's a big disincentive against doing activism, because all of a sudden people are going to have opinions about you that they've never had before, and that could be uncomfortable for people.
Yeah, and well, of course, donation does avoid that mostly. I don't publish my donor lists. I assume you don't either.
That's correct. Unless the person wants recognition, which we've done with our satellite fundraiser, where people could opt in and say, "Yeah, put my name on a list."
Oh yeah, eventually you'll be able to buy a sainthood from the Church of the Invisible Hand.
James,
I just haven't decided the price.
I don't need to be a saint, but I'd like some dispensation for some stuff.
James, thanks for your call.
We can do that.
I appreciate it. Toll free number. tonight is 855-450-FREE. So we've been sharing a kind of a critical piece here from ethanglover.biz about some of the activism that Rich and I have recently done with confronting the governor. He goes on with some of his opinions here. He says, to find the gold in the situation that could have been better been dug, we'll continue looking at our example of arguing on the internet. Instead of jumping into a pit of lions, we can head to the pet store and choose the cutest, most well-behaved puppy from the lot. That is to say, finding groups of people who are open to discussion, communicating with them, and making friends with those closest to your own ideals. To use the first example that comes to mind, consider that the personality type INTJ, which is introverted, intuitive thinking, judging, seems to be the most common among libertarian circles.
INTJs and ENTJs, yeah.
With this revelation, you may find it personally beneficial as well as beneficial to the movement to join an INTJ forum. Act as a regular member, put your voice out there on different issues, and be honest about yourself. In time, you'll find people who are willing to debate with you and agree with you. And I don't think that's a terrible idea for somebody who wants to spend time discussing things on the internet. Better to go where people are already, at the very least, more likely to agree with you on some things than to jump into the the lion's den, as he pointed out before. That's not a bad suggestion.
Yeah, I look in the Church of the Flying Spaghetti Monster, which the Church of the Invisible Hand does recognize him as a prophet. We just deny his divinity. I go there. I go to other places. I even go to Democrat groups sometimes and kind of politically cross-dress, because the thing is there are liberal and conservative reasons for freedom. So, a lot of what I try to do is political cross-dressing where I give people the reasons that are going to be meaningful to them.
It'll resonate with their viewpoint. You're putting on the cloak of that perspective, essentially, better communicate with them.
If I'm arguing economics with a liberal, I argue welfare economics and that everybody will be better off. If I'm arguing economics with somebody who's more of a conservative, I'll say, I don't generally have to do as much, but I'll use their principle that markets should be free and say, well, in this area we're arguing about, markets should also be free, because obviously a conservative is going to have holdouts where he says, oh no, markets shouldn't be free in that area.
Like drugs.
I mean, oftentimes one of the things that I like to point out to conservatives is that, hey, look, oftentimes when you think about government bureaucrats, usually you think about meddling, officious, maybe even downright evil individuals that ruin people's lives. But it seems like that when people, when the government puts guns in the hands of government bureaucrats, suddenly you think they're all heroes. And I want to know how you justify that in your mind. How come the cops and the soldiers and even firefighters, I guess I don't carry guns generally except for fire marshals, how come they're heroes? But the rest of the government bureaucrats aren't.
855-450-FREE. Join us on Free Talk Live.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
Every summer we go to Canyon Woods. Love getting outside. Love the hiking. Hate the itching and irritation from poison ivy, bug bites, all the things that keep me inside. So I need something strong.
Cortisone 10 Intensive Healing is clinically proven with the strongest non-prescription itch medicine available for fast, long-lasting relief of itching and irritation with 7 moisturizers to help heal skin.
I finally have the relief I need.
Hey, Jan, check this out.
On my way.
Cortisone 10. Feel the heal.
If you constantly feel run down and tired, your pH level might be low and your body could be full of toxins. If what you drink is not at a pH level of 8 or higher, you are inviting bacteria and acid to thrive in your body. But there is something you can do. Simply add 10 drops of AlkaVision plasma pH drops to your water to help your body rid itself of acidic waste, increase oxygen, and raise your pH balance to optimum levels. AlkaVision plasma pH drops combine a unique formula of the most alkaline minerals in the world, alkalizing the water you you drink, ridding your body of acidic waste and toxins, and helping you regain energy and vibrant health. And studies show viruses, bacteria, and toxins cannot survive in an alkaline, high pH environment. Order your bottle of AlkaVision Plasma pH Drops at AlkaVision.com. That's AlkaVision.com. Or call 269-409-1776. 269-409-1776. Alkalize your body. Supercharge your health at AlkaVision.com today.
A congressman recently revealed that legislation totaling 2,900 pages and involving more than $1 trillion was available to members of Congress for less than 48 hours to study and consider. That's over 60 pages of legislation per hour. Do you think anyone read the entire bill? I'm Jim Babka with DownsizeDC.org. Consider a proposal buried in a 3,200-page, $388 billion bill, which would have empowered committee chairmen or their agents to examine Americans' tax returns. When this horrible provision came to light, no one claimed to know how it got into the bill. One congressman questioned said, "I didn't write it, I didn't approve it, I wasn't even consulted." If your attorney represented you this way, he might be disbarred. But this is how Congress represents you every day. That's why DownsizeDC.org has created the Read the Bills Act. You can force Congress to read their bills before they pass them at DownsizeDC.org.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938, 877-357-9938.
You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. We've got a few moments left for you if you want to dial in and join us here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online over at freetalklive.com. Don't forget to check out Rich over at richpaul.freekeen.com. That'll take you to a page with some of his projects, including the Church of the Invisible Hand, which is well worth looking into. You can also join us, of course, over at freetalklive.com. And if you want to help support Free Talk Live, please amp the show for $5 a month. That's $5 that we can take and invest into Free Talk Live to get on more radio stations, bring more internet listeners on board, and expose new people to the ideas of freedom. You get perks like access to the AMP-only call-in lines, AMP-only forum, and the AMP-only Facebook group. Go and get the details and get signed up, please. Makes a big difference for us over at amp.freetalklive.com. That's amp.freetalklive.com. Back to the somewhat critical article from Ethan Glover at ethanglover.biz. I don't think we're going to get through it here tonight, but I'll put it, link it up on our Facebook and Twitter. This will be the last night we talk about it, because I think we've gotten the gist generally of where he's coming from thus far. But he goes on to say here, so long as you're not a pusher for liberty, but rather a representative of your own mind, you will find beneficial conversation in which people will honestly consider what you have to say and move down the path of liberty. If you make yourself—
I find that often in my life when I talk to people, is that I'm not out there pushing this other than on my show.
Right.
I certainly am a big pusher. But in real life, I'm not out there trying to shove these ideas down people's throats.
No, me neither. It doesn't work. You've got to
really?
Be
you were
there.
Just out there yelling
most
at the governor.
Of the people that
I'm not
I
trying to convert
to.
The governor, Mark.
Most of the people that I talk to about liberty come up and talk to me because they're aware of my activism. That's how they know who I am and mm-hmm. that I'm somebody that if they're thinking about liberty that maybe they might want to talk to. So they're to me, what he's saying there is symbiotic with what we've already been doing.
Yeah, I agree with that. Like, for instance, my approach when I was in jail was to just kind of mind my own business and, you know, be interested at the very least in other people's stories. And then eventually I figured somebody might ask me a question about what I thought. And eventually that did happen. But I never did push anything on anybody. And cornering the governor with some hard questions isn't the same thing as having relationships with real people in real life, right? That's a performance art. That's what we were doing. Yeah. Essentially was performance, street theater, if you will, to some extent. Not really street theater, but performance art. Political performance, and for the purpose of putting a message out there to the rest of the world, not to the people who are standing next to the governor.
She's paid very well to hold the opinions that she holds.
What do they pay the governor in New Hampshire?
Well, it's not just what
really?
They pay him, it's also what goes into their campaign.
Yes.
And, you know, she makes a lot of money. I guarantee that her increase of net worth in a year is more than her salary.
Seriously? It's more than $100,000? I'm shocked by that, considering that New Hampshire only pays their state reps $100 per year. Are you 100% sure on that, Mark?
That's what I recall having seen. I'm taking a look.
I think that's accurate.
Wow.
I think state reps are the only ones who get very low pay.
The state senate gets $100 a year.
Yeah, they do.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Yeah,
$122,000 a year.
Wow.
Now, it doesn't say win, but it says the compensation is $122,000.
One of the Liberty reps should put a bill in to cut that down, like cut it down to 20 or something like that, to nothing, you know, to something you could subsist on.
That's an interesting thought. Then again, it does increase the, I mean, not that any of them aren't corrupt now, but it might make corruption even worse, because rather than seeking a salary, people would be almost solely seeking what can they make by being in office.
But it's a weak governorship. They can't do very much, right?
It's relatively weak comparatively. And, you know, the fact that in New Hampshire we have so many ideologues that run for things, I think that you're less likely to find the rent-seeking behavior. Not to say you won't find it. I'm just saying you're less likely to find it.
Yeah.
So he says, let's see, in the case of the Colbert Report on Robin Hooding, I noted that business outreach would ultimately be more beneficial than filling parking meters. It wouldn't get media attention and maybe no attention at all. That's the issue so eloquently described by Dan Carlin at the beginning of this article, but it would make a difference. It would create discussion that matters more, but on a smaller scale. It may even create the better end result of local businesses aiming to buy the parking meters or even the streets from the city of Keene.
But I've never cared about Robin Hooding as activism, you know, like from that standpoint. For me, what it's good for is that it gets people's attention outside of New Hampshire, people who might want to do some kind of activism and might want to move.
The amount of press attention, he admits here that going and talking to business owners in downtown Keene would likely not garner any attention from the media, which, by the way, we didn't start doing Robin Hooding expecting to get attention from the media. We started doing Robin Hooding because we wanted to save people from getting parking tickets. For those that don't know, Robin Hooding, and you've done it, Rich, so you know, is putting coins in expired meters prior to the arrival of a ticketing agent to prevent someone from getting a ticket. We went and did this for months and months and years, and finally the city filed a lawsuit against six of the Robin Hooders, one of which was me, and then the media explosion happened. Then it became an international headline that was happening all across the world, foreign publications, foreign language, MSNBC, Fox News, ABC News, you know, Good Morning America. All of these groups covered Robin Hooding. That the amount of dollars that level of time is worth, the Colbert Report. I mean, that was a 7-minute presentation or whatever on the Colbert Report. The amount of money you would have to spend to make the equivalent of that amount of airtime is an unfathomable amount of money. So to say that, you know, Robin Hooding should have been done differently or whatever, great, go out and talk to the business owners. This once again comes back to what we were saying before. If you feel like Rich and I's activism is poor or could be done better, it's fine to critique us online, or better yet, call in toll-free and join us here at 855-450-FREE. That's all fine. I'm happy to have a conversation. But if you think you've got a better idea, don't ask us to do it for you, because we got enough on our plate. We've all got a lot going on here. You step up and you go out there and, you know, if you want to talk to the business owners on Main Street about buying the parking meters, which would be completely likely unpolitically feasible, but you could talk to them anyway and see how that goes. Try it out, and then let us know how that works out.
It's true.
going on here. He says, this is what I refer to as a more precise approach because it targets and gets support from the people who can benefit from your ideas. Well, guess what? There's a lot of people who support Robinhood. We've had countless contributions, mm-hmm. both cash handed to you in hand when you're on the streets, people mm-hmm. thanking the Robinhooders in the streets, checks being cut and mailed to the Robinhooding residents, Bitcoin contributions, mm-hmm. PayPal donations. All
and
of those are indications
that
people appreciate.
When somebody comes up and puts money in your hand and says, I love what you're doing, you know they really mean it.
Absolutely.
And for me, the big thing about Robinhood is basically we were paying 30 cents for the privilege of putting a piece of propaganda on somebody's car. Mm. And I thought that was a great price because it also left that person very inclined to be receptive to that propaganda. The thing that I never liked about Robinhood is I didn't like the amount of rhetoric and the level of hostility that was shown to the parking enforcers. I think sometimes that went over the top, and I think that is a thing where if somebody is well disposed toward you personally, they are more inclined to care about what you think of them, and therefore mm-hmm. they're more inclined to accept your ideas or understand them, or at least appear to understand them. So there is something there when you say don't piss people off so much that they can't hear your message, but at the same time, you know, take it.
Well, I was going to say to that, I know where you're coming from, and we've had a discussion about this. This is something we disagree on. I've mm-hmm. never been mean, in my opinion, to the parking enforcers, but one of them is particularly nasty to me. And uh-huh. if she's going to be nasty to me, I'm going to pull out a video camera and I'm going to show people how she's behaving. Now, people didn't like that I sort of tracked her with the camera in one instance where she kept turning around, going back and forth, basically covering the same ground over and over again. She turns around 180 degrees 18 times in a 2-minute time frame.
It's very strange.
And
behavior.
I turned it into a fun video where I played a little like Mario sound effect of ding, ding, whenever she would turn around. And yeah, I made fun of her for acting in a very erratic and silly manner. But I would never have done it had she not have been jumping out into traffic, trying to evade me and being very ridiculous and dangerous. So I brought that camera out for a very specific purpose, and it was because mm-hmm. she was the one who was behaving crazy, and I feel like that needed to be shown.
Right. Yeah, there are some cases where I think that some of the things said to the parking attendants, and I'm not thinking of you specifically.
Okay.
I'm
talking about Graham or somebody else?
Yeah, okay. Actually, it was Graham that I...
Well, he hasn't Robin Hooded for more than a year.
He hasn't Robin Hooded for a long time, but he made us some enemies when he did.
What can you do?
And
you
some know? Friends.
And that's the thing. With activism, you can't control who goes out and says, I'm with them, and then goes and does something stupid, right? We've seen that at the 420s where people, there was a guy who jumped out in front of an ambulance, and a cop later talked to me like, do you support this? He was with your group. And I'm like, I don't even know who you're talking about, right? So you never know who's going to try to associate themselves with you to make you look bad if you're in public. Anyway, we'll be back tomorrow night online. In the meantime, freetalklive.com.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here. And I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, Mark at freetalklive.com. Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
Rebel Love Show is next, live after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Tuesday, May 19th, 2015. Silver is trading at $17.53 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,221 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $234. Antiwar.com reports the authorization for use of military force for the war against the Islamic State, which has been raging for 9 months now, has still not been brought to a vote, and the recent indications are it probably never will be. Representative Adam Schiff of California said the snag is there is no real political will or interest in doing this, saying no vote on the war would be a terrible precedent. Yet that seems to be where things are headed, as the White House unveiled its proposed AUMF bill and quickly alienated most of the public by saying it was deliberately vague to allow them to expand the war at will. In the lead up to last November's election, there was little interest in a politically volatile vote, and now that the war has been going on so long, most of the Republican leadership, which supports the war at any rate, seems to see no need to put anything on paper. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. UPI reports President Obama announced federal standards to improve trust between police and communities and a ban on some types of military equipment for local police agencies. Obama spoke on the measures Monday in Camden, New Jersey, a city that has struggled with one of the country's highest violent crime rates. A blueprint for improved community policing was announced that will help cities and towns develop policing strategies that work best for building trust between law enforcement and the communities they serve while enhancing public safety. Obama pointed to work Camden has done to grow trust between the city's residents and its police force and a subsequent drop in violent crime, murder, and open-air drug markets. The White House will attempt to create improved methods of using data and technologies in ways to build community trust and reduce unnecessary uses of force. The Department of Justice recently announced a new program that will help law enforcement agencies implement the use of body-worn cameras on officers, which will be further supported by the White House. Tools cities can utilize will be presented as part of the Task Force on 21st Century Policing program that can be used to build and maintain the all-important trust between the law enforcement officers and the communities they have sworn to serve and protect. Meanwhile, the White House announced a list of items that are banned from being acquired by local police under select federal programs. The list includes tracked armored vehicles, weaponized aircrafts and vehicles, bayonets, grenade launchers, and large caliber firearms. During his speech in Camden, Obama said, "We've seen how militarized gear sometimes gives people a feeling like they're an occupying force as opposed to part of a community they're there to protect. Some equipment made for the battlefield is not appropriate for local police departments." Under more rigorous control, law enforcement agencies will still be able to acquire armored vehicles, tactical vehicles, riot gear, and specialized firearms and ammunition. In Survivor Max by Davi Barker, 11-year-old Max must survive the zombie apocalypse alone in New Hampshire. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the lame brains swarm his home searching for living flesh. Max must apply his porcupine Freedom Scouts training to plan his escape, but first, he must prove that he's too smart to die. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook and Amazon, or read Chapter 1 free at SurvivorMax.com.
Reuters reports four passengers on the Amtrak commuter train that derailed in Philadelphia last week filed a federal lawsuit on Monday against the rail service. The lawsuit filed in Philadelphia cited serious and disabling injuries from the May 12th derailment that killed eight people and injured more than 200 others. Nearly a week after the derailment, it remains a mystery what caused the train to accelerate from 70 miles per hour to 106 miles per hour in a minute before the crash. Authorities have not yet ruled out equipment malfunction, human error, or other possible reasons for the train gaining speed so rapidly. This lawsuit appears to be the first filed by a non-employee of Amtrak. Last week, an Amtrak employee who was riding the train as a passenger filed the first lawsuit, citing a brain injury he suffered in the crash. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Florida officials announced today its plan to experiment with new 600-lever voting machines.
The machine operates through a very straightforward process that we think is going to give Floridians the peace of mind that their votes will be counted. The voter turns on the machine using these 30 levers at the top and then enters their names and social security numbers using the alphanumeric levers near the bottom here. Right about now, the voter is going to have to find the two levers on the machine that are exactly identical and pull them at the same time. Then they're going to have to...
The new 22-foot-tall steam-powered machines, which officials are hailing as, quote, the future of voting, each feature over 45 separate panels of levers, along with an intricate series of valves, knobs, cranks, and pumps, all designed to streamline the electoral process.
Now, some of this may seem confusing, but every voter will be given a comprehensive 2,200-page manual when they enter their precinct that will explain exactly what to do.
This is the Onion News Network.
Welcome to the Rebel Love Show, where we are a once-a-week broadcast from Manchester, New Hampshire, where we are pro-pot, pro-gun, and pro-coffee. You're listening to us live on Alaren.fm, IPM Nation, and now LMR. I am Ron Mathias.
And I'm Shire Dude.
And today our guest is none other than the one, the only, Derek J. Freeman.
Real.
Worms. So, Derek, you said you were inspired by one of our previous episodes about a THC cleanse.
Yeah, you know, it just sort of happened by accident. Like, I wasn't smoking for a while. First of all, I was running out of money, and I was just like, it would be less money if I didn't go out and buy this cannabis. So I just stopped doing that, because I, like, after a while, I couldn't justify the crazy cost of, like, how much... In weight would alcohol cost?
Oh, I know.
Versus cannabis. It's not that I'm an alcohol guy. I actually hate alcohol. I hate how it makes me feel, so I stay away. But it was the cost that I was like, how much? Like I've quit smoking before. I've added up like thousands of dollars that I've saved by quitting smoking cigarettes.
Yeah.
So I wanted to see what I could do without cannabis, and it was good. It was good. I didn't have any effects like, oh, I need the cannabis. You know, people talk about like drug addiction or psychological addiction. It wasn't anything like that. It was easy. So I went over 3 weeks, and now today I am packing a bowl to enjoy with you folks.
Well, we feel honored that you held the THC cleanse for us. We couldn't make it
to our... It's difficult.
Yeah, we were going to hold it for 3 weeks, but because we have a hiatus on the first week of every month for the New Movers Party, because that's the same time that we're on.
Worms.
Yeah. So so we actually ended up doing it right before that party instead of waiting for the whole next episode. But yeah, we couldn't hold out on the wait. I'm impressed that you were able to go 3 weeks.
Yeah, man. It was easy. You guys asked me to hold it, and I was like, all right. I was going to... Yeah, I was going to go get some.
It wasn't easy.
Anyway, this is Jack Herrera, which is my favorite strain of cannabis. High-quality headies. So, who's got a lighter?
Oh, you got a... Oh. That'd be an issue. Oh, you should have a lighter.
Oh, there we go.
Thank you, sir.
One of the benefits of having a live studio audience.
I know, right?
Rebel Loves Studios.
The Rebel Loves Studios. But feel free. No, it's you. This is all you. All right. It'd be an honor for you to hit it up first.
Right into the mic. Is there a camera on?
Oh yeah, I got a camera on you right now.
It's on. Extra incriminating.
Yeah. Oh, so while Derek's smoking, you can see him at rebelloveshow.com. If you go to live, you can see the studio cam and the chat room is on there, so you can chat with us. I'll be sure to jump into that chat.